Secure transmission established. This is Keeper. We may speak freely, Agent. Prepare to receive your orders.
I'm ready, sir. What's the assignment?
In short, subversion. You were chosen for this operation because of your exemplary performance during training. Imperial intelligence needs agents capable of working independently in the field. Now you apply your training to the real world. Nemro the Hutt and his organization run Jaguna. And you're in town to convince Nemro to supply the Empire.
Give me background. What are we working from?
Jaguna is an industrial town, and Nemro runs most of the industry. The Hutt plies weapons, drugs, and raw materials. But not to us. We believe Nemro has been reluctant to lose Republic customers by publicly siding with the Empire. It's time he overcame this reluctance.
By force? Or did you have another method in mind?
It's too early to say for certain. We need to know what Nemro and his advisors are thinking before we can act. I want you to obtain access to the Nemro clan's inner circle. You'll require a cover identity. One of our contacts, an alien named G, has prepared a background for you and will provide the details.
How do I find him?
G will be waiting for you at a safe house. Locate him, take what he offers, then report to me.
Are we sure this contact is trustworthy?
Jig won't betray us. Whether he succeeds at his assigned tasks is another matter. I'd be more concerned with the rest of the populace. Most of Jaguna is caught up in a turf war. Some of the gangs involved belong to the Hutts. Others are independent. Your combat training should see you through, but expect brutality and expect to be targeted. Jaguna isn't friendly to strangers. Now, find Jig and report back to me. Keeper out.
Smogus total gis baba apiatai.
Talk fast. I don't want to be seen with you.
Orso total man. Vataranai angomis akananol. Alas protas era. Gratai aptite. Iruprit virtini savasia savebe caegis.
If there's another red blade out there, won't that be a problem?
Smalsio poputus mana ira patare mananan kali. Vataranai angomis akananol, alas protas era.
What kind of interference?
Acrodo nomales, smogas total gis bavo apiatai. Gratai aptite, iruprit virtini savasia savebe caegis.
Let's make this fast and quiet then.
Acrodo nomales, smogas total gis bavo apiatai. Vataranai angomis akananol, alas protas era. Atrodo nomales, smogas total gis bavo apiatai. Sio taisec la prasma era. Padra vimos brandimus prostis cad at veritag.
You've done well. The Empire is grateful to you.
Francija baja as at vexia. Vataranai angomis akananol, alas protas era.
Jig, from this point forward, operational security will be at a premium. You will not contact us from this terminal again.
Smalsio poputus mana ira patare mananan kali.
I understand you corrected Jeek's mishandling of the situation, Agent. We'll now proceed.
Acknowledged and understood.
Your next task is to access Nemro's inner circle. Present yourself to the Hutt as a fellow gangster, the Red Blade, and offer him Jeeg's gifts. One of the gifts is implanted with a listening device, which we will use to monitor conversations within Nemro's palace.
Are you listening for something specific?
At this juncture, our primary goal is to find weaknesses in Nemro's organization. Even if the Hutt won't join us, we might influence his lieutenants. Talk to Nemro and his men. Determine who we can turn and how we can sway them. We will be listening.
I'll be back once I learn anything.
Be careful what you say. And lose the accent. When you're in the Hutt Palace, you're no longer an Imperial. Contact me from the cantina once Nemro has his presence. Keep her out.
The pirate's on her way. Security droids say she's armed, but she won't be trouble.
Let's hope not. Here she is now.
I'll go tell the boss.
This is Carol's. Tell the throne room that the Blade's arrived. When Nemro shows, stay at least 5 meters back and don't come up unless you're called. One wrong move, and you're a pile of ash.
I understand. I'm not here to cause trouble.
Just going over the rules. You've got a reputation, and we don't want any problems. Allow me to present Nemro the Hutt, the illustrious crime king of Jiguna.
Kutsi nanji hai, ja to ni ma te chu. Gadwa chi ne bohiga, na nulia okba ki sa spina perupa. Dodi buna buna, manji ka bog nonis nemo.
Trinkets, great Nemro. Nothing more.
Kava dompa stupa, makin salika.
Not bad. Nemro, the idols here are real Orodium. The cloth looks like...
Manama asha picho. Kipuna malituta odmishka kabano tazema. Ki obakili wata bangi danko batoga wata.
We have business to discuss.
Kunchuta kasu yali koira tokanti kong.
Of course, mighty Nemro.
Kikuna mo, uban chone alipa, istin koto.
Konchuta, kasu yali koira, tokanti kong.
Looks like your audience with Nemro is over. You'll have to forgive the interruption. I've been working for that Hutt since he killed my gang when I was 13. Trust me, you can't talk to him when he's like this.
What's all this about Fathra?
We're having trouble with the Fathra clan, and it's getting to all of us. Fathra's out of line, but the Hutt cartel hasn't bothered to interfere.
So it's a business dispute. What are you feuding over?
Everything. The mines, the factories, the slaving operations. Now look, I need to work up new plans with security, and keep an eye on Tothlajin to keep him from suggesting anything stupid. In the meantime, you're a guest, and you've got our permission to do business here. You got the run of the palace, so I'll see you around.
Well done, Agent. The listening device is working perfectly, and Nemro can keep no more secrets from us. Imperial intelligence has determined that Nemro's human lieutenant, Carlos Jarvis, is the weak link in his operation. You're going to twist the man until he serves us.
He won't be any trouble to manipulate.
Unfortunately, Carlos is on the verge of disfavor with Nemro, while the Twi'lek Lieutenant Tothlajin, I believe, is Nemro's rising star. I want you to go to Kettles and offer your services as the Red Blade. Do whatever is required to bring Kettles glory in Nemro's eyes.
What does Nemro have against Carol's?
Kettle's work has been suffering due to the interference of the Fothra clan. Nemro finds that an unacceptable excuse for failure. One other thing, Agent. This operation of ours has drawn the attention of a member of the Dark Council, Darth Jadus himself. The Council's authority is second only to that of the Emperor. It's a rare honor for an intelligence operation to be overseen in this way.
I believe I understand, sir. I won't disappoint you.
Report back once you've rendered whatever aid Kettles requires. Keep her out.
Don't be in such a hurry, Blade. Don't you remember me? Your old buddy, Dino Ray? I don't think you looked this good when we met up on Hoth. Or so girly. But you couldn't be an imposter, you know your friend Dino.
Of course I remember you, Dino. How long it's been.
Little too long, it seems. Turns out we got a problem. You see, you don't look like the Blade I know. The Blade who owes me credits. But you say you're the Blade, my pretty lady friend. So I'll take you at your word and ask for my money. You understand?
Maybe we can deal. How much money are we talking about?
Let's see, I could factor in interest, what you did to my ship. But that's not how pals do things. Yeah, I don't know where the real Blade is, and I don't care. But if you want me to keep your secret, I'll need enough credits to keep me comfortable.
I don't have a choice. I can't let you talk.
Is that so? Well, let's see what you can do, Blade.
Blade, come on over. Glad to see you're enjoying the palace. Look, I've only got 5 minutes before I have to go meet with some alien freaks, and I want to ask you something. You've been around the galaxy a few times. What's it like dealing with the Empire?
It's been good business, and the government hasn't given me much trouble.
You're one of the last real independents. I admire you for that, but your kind is dying out. The Hutts have taken control of the gangs, and I think real soon the Republican Empire will want control of the Hutts, even if Nimra won't believe it. So, if we gotta pick a side, I want to pick a winner, and I don't see the Empire losing.
Sounds reasonable, but what are you gonna do about it?
For starters, I make sure I'm not being stupid. There's more on the line than business. My sons are free traders. They're doing business in the Solar System. It's their first time dealing with the Empire, so I worry. I probably shouldn't. But you came to me for a reason. What can I do for you, Blade?
You know Hutta pretty well, but you don't have my skills. I thought we could partner up for a job.
Is that right? Normally I wouldn't, but lately I could use someone who works alone and gets results. Nemro's been stewing in his slime since we lost a shipment of rare ores in the Evokai lands. He blames me for some reason. Now the Evokai, they're Hutta natives from before the cartel came. They mostly want us dead. If you get that shipment back, I'll pay you good.
All right. I'm interested.
Then maybe we both come out ahead. There's a work camp outside Jaguna. Nimro set it up for some Evokai who wanted peace. Bad deal, poor rubes. The chief there, Odef, was supposed to talk to the other Evokai tribes about returning the ore, but he didn't come through. He knows something, though. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have an appointment to keep. But I look forward to seeing if the Red Blade's as good as they say. Come back when you found my missing shipment, Blade. I don't have time for conversation.
You said you were going to get the ore back.
I have done all I can. They, the other tribes, will not listen.
If you say so. Hey, you the Red Blade? Heard you were coming. Thought we'd soften up the chief for you.
Carol sent me. I'll take it from here.
He's all yours.
I am Odef of the Evokai, leader of the Vorm, sacred keeper of histories. I greet you in peace, and I am grateful.
I heard you're the one to talk to about Nemro's missing ore.
Yes. I will talk. But it will not please you. It was the other tribes who attacked your shipment, the Evokai, who refused peace. In gratitude to Nemro for all he has done, I spoke to my misguided brothers, but they will not return Nemro's medals.
They won't even negotiate.
The tribes, they stole the shipment to spite the huts and to use for themselves. They will make weapons, machines. They took the metals to their great village in the swamps. Only a beast or a shadow can enter. Seek the shipment there if you wish.
Thank you. You've been a great help.
I only do my part. I only want peace.
Slow down, Blade. Stay with me a while. We haven't had the chance to talk. I'm Kaleo. Nemro puts me in charge of the good stuff. His guns, his troops, the safety of his little palace. You can spare some time for me, right?
I'm in sort of a hurry right now. You'll have to make it quick.
Probably eager to get back outside. Blow the heads off a few locals. See who's stupid enough to act tough. I'm more interesting. Promise. You've got a nasty reputation, you know. I hear you went and murdered poor Dino Ray right on this spot. What was that about, Blade?
Dino and I go way back. He had it coming.
It's too bad. He had a pretty face before you messed with it. Me. I'm betting you and Dino had something else going on. You had a reason for coming to Nemro's house. Maybe money. Maybe power. I like to think you'll be trouble, Blade. You'll be bloodthirsty. Treacherous. Because I could enjoy keeping an eye on a bloodthirsty, treacherous pirate.
You got a strange idea of fun, lady.
I get bored easily. Even hot perversions get old after a while. If you are trouble, take your time. I'd hate to stick a blaster to your head, or a slave collar around your neck, before I've seen everything you can do. That's all I wanted to say. You can go now.
It's been a pleasure, Kaleo.
Of course it has.
Fathra will not stop his mining operations. He's going to keep tapping our gas pocket and cut our supply in half.
Oka kiza spida perupa. Kadwa shiniko higa danulia.
Don't play dumb with me, Tathlajin. Fathra doesn't need to steal our customers if he doesn't leave us any gas to sell, and we can't uproot him without help.
Punyu kichawa joto jamba.
Idiot. Sorry about Tathlajin, Blade. Legitimate business brings out the worst in us. Makes me miss actual crime, you know? But it looks like you're about to brighten my day. You find the shipment?
I have it right here, delivered as promised.
The fee's been transferred to your account. You'll have access by the time you're back at your apartments. You earned every credit. I'd buy you a drink in the cantina, but I need to have a chat with Nimro. We should talk more another time, though. You do good work.
I appreciate it, Carols. Good luck with the hut.
Right. I'll need it.
The operation is proceeding well, Agent. Thanks to your intervention, Carols Jarvis will once again have Nemro's ear. I took note of your meeting with Nemro's security chief, Kaleo. You handled yourself well. Still be on your guard. We've identified her as a freelance assassin, enforcer, and anarchist. She's been attached to a dozen employers in half as many years, using several different aliases.
I'll be cautious.
She's a wild card. She may prove a liability, but she could also prove very useful. Watch her. On to more immediate concerns. Nemro operates a major Schwash gas mine on Hutter. The Empire wants access to Nemro's refined gas. Unfortunately, Fathra is tapping the same gas pocket as Nemro. We need to destroy Fathra's operations in the rust yards before Nemro's grinds to a halt.
So it's a sabotage mission?
That's correct. You will travel to Fathra's mining facility and place explosives in the drill shaft, destroying the equipment and collapsing part of the gas pocket. You'll need to strip a uniform and credentials off the facility guards to pass the final security checkpoint. A working disguise is imperative.
Should be straightforward.
Your disguise may not hold up under close inspection, so avoid conversation. The explosives have already been delivered to your room. Once you're finished, go back to Carlos Jarvis and make sure he knows what happened. Take the credit if you like.
It'll be handled. Is there anything else?
One more thing, Agent. Darth Jadis pays increasing attention to your work. He will reward success or failure appropriately, and I will not intervene. Report back after you've destroyed the mine and inform Carols of the results. Keep her out.
Cartel representative identity confirmed. Entry authorized. Gas leak detected. Activating ventilation system. Lockdown in place until ventilation complete. Recalling all mining and security droids.
You'll get the gory details after I report to Nemro. Figure you can wait that long?
Looks like I'll have to. But you don't get...
Blade, nice you decided to come by, but I was just telling Carols I can't stay. I know you understand.
That girl's a handful. But she's good at what she does, I'll give her that.
I'll have to take your word for it.
Anyways, I'm glad you're here. Those explosions in the rust yards, you wouldn't know anything about that, would you?
I took out Father's mining operations. I heard they were giving you trouble.
I thought you might have something to do with it. Good work, Blade. Good work. I like a person who takes initiative. With Fathra's mines broke down, we can increase production. Fathra will want revenge, of course, but we'll be ready. Look, I have something for you. You'll like it. I'll send it to your room. You've done good work for us. You deserve more than credits. Which reminds me, how long are you staying on Hutta?
I really wish I knew the answer to that.
Well, if you're still around in a few weeks, I'd like you to meet my sons. They'll be home from the trading expedition. I think you'd get along. Think about it, is all I'm saying. Now get going. I'm sure you have other business to take care of.
Come on, Lunti, we don't have time to waste here.
Yeta chupa chawa aita.
Too late. Hey there, you must be the Blade.
You made a mistake coming in here. You're not leaving this place alive.
You think? Let's find out. Get your guns out, folks.
I understand Nemro Schwarz gas production is back on schedule, Agent. Excellent work. Keep it up, and Darth Jadis may loosen his grip on operations. However, I'm afraid unforeseen circumstances have caused a problem.
What kind of problem?
3 days ago, Carlos Jarvis's sons encountered a Sith apprentice in Imperial space. A dispute broke out. One son died and the other was crippled. When Carlos hears that a Sith slaughtered his child, his sympathy for the Empire will evaporate. We can no longer use him to get to Nemro.
Can we keep him from finding out?
No. Carlos is close to his sons, and the circumstances of the encounter aren't exactly secret. He'll learn sooner or later. Now, I have a plan to solve our present dilemma, but first we need Carlos out of the way.
Are you sure that's necessary?
It's unfortunate, but it's the only way to proceed. I'm sending you an interference program on a computer spike. Go to Carlos's suites in the palace. Activate the spike to black out his security monitors. You'll be able to eliminate Carlos and his bodyguards without being seen. When Nemro's people investigate, they'll recognize the jamming program as Republic technology.
So we frame the Republic for the murder of Carlos Jarvis. Why?
One step at a time, Agent. Tothlish and Nemro's Twi'lek advisor already expect Fathra to seek revenge for the destruction of his mines. Our job is to show that the Republic helped Fathra kill Carlos. Once Carlos is gone, speak to Tothlishin about his suspicions. As Carlos's friend, you'll promise to do whatever it takes to find the assassins.
Time to get to work.
For now, get to Carol's suites and use the computer, Spike. We'll discuss more once Carol's is eliminated and Tarthagen's suspicions have been aroused. Keep her out.
What's going on here? You thought you'd just go and switch sides? Damn you!
I'm sorry, Carol's. It's nothing personal.
I don't understand. I helped you. I trusted you. We had a bond. And now you murder my men, wave a weapon in my face? But I guess that doesn't matter much. So let's go. You and me, Blade. The young punk against the old gang leader.
I wish it could have been different. You deserve better.
You think you're the first piece of scum who's tried to kill me? I was fighting thugs in Jaguna streets when I was half your age. I can handle you.
Piti do tenya go kaka jojo, da biska ku paliya.
Tiliska chanaga wa ni chikos pa inikudade. Nu janti chawa, choto ke guanga joska.
Chakita huta, kunta chuta, kaso yali kulira. Kanki Kung.
What are you talking about? Carol's is dead?
Manchi do ti puna puna. Kabuk nuni slemo. Kabano tase makipuna. Mali tuta udmishka. Piti do tenya go kaka jojo. Da biska ku paliya.
I'll do whatever it takes to bring the killers to justice.
Mana matota jispa micho. Pliska taka, ya yoska ukle yuga chesko pukuta. Yinga yinga kijita, nimni tanuv, alelo kwekuta. Kunta chuta, kasu yali kulira, kanki kung. Oka kiza spida perupa, kadwa shiniko higa danulia.
I'll look into it. Might take some time.
Atoga wata kiko uba kiri wata buki donko. Buka kampak nijit. Tonka yiliska chanaga.
So, this is where you've been hiding. Nice. Is the blood on the floor fresh, or did that come with the room?
You shouldn't have come here. We already played this game.
True. But the rules are a little different this time. You've been all over town, racking up quite a body count. And I know what you did to Carol's. You're after something bigger than Emerald. I'm not sure what, and I'm not sure why. But I want in on it.
Fine. I'm sure we can work something out.
I knew we could get along. So where do we start?
Allow me to respond to that.
What's this now?
We know who you are, Kaleo Janus, and we are willing to offer you a deal. I am Keeper. I represent Imperial Intelligence, as does my operative. We are aware of your activities on Rat Attack, Ord Mantell, and Brentall's Fall, as well as your affiliations. Your skills could prove useful, and we are willing to offer you a place in our ranks. You would become a very well-paid servant of the Empire.
I've heard worse propositions. What do you think, Agent? You want me on your side?
You could be an asset to us. I won't object.
I was looking to trade up anyway. And I'm guessing I can ride you a ways before you break. Count me in. But call me a servant of the Empire again, and I'll bust your face.
Charming. We'll discuss the details later. As for you, Agent, Tarthagen is convinced that Bothra the Hutt is a major threat to business. Well done. Now we must bring Tarthagen proof that Bothra has support from the Republic. The first step is to obtain a holodisk from Bothra's palace. The disk contains holo recordings of all Bothra's dealings. The Hutt is too paranoid for his own good. You'll have to break into his archive to get it.
It'll mean lifting security codes off the palace overseers. Like you said, paranoid hut.
Noted. Once you reach the archives, use this computer spike on the holodisk. It will be altered to show Fathra meeting with Republic officers. Then bring the forgery to Tothlegion.
I could use a break from the tough jobs.
Tothlegion, convinced that his enemies are allied with the Galactic Republic, have no doubt. He will turn to us for help. We are in the endgame. Leo will accompany you on this mission and will act under your command.
Last time I went to Fathra's palace, I had so many adrenals in my system, I was coming down for a week. This should be entertaining.
Malambiamgin, hamgam nea pe kabrakawa. Manala yang perlu. Amka kalami naya kira nubua.
Hello, Nan. What brings you down here? Fathra finally ordered you to check out the shooting?
Nulilak apa jam kamgram. Amka nem nang nemua inuk. Kali ruma. Mereka baka lebik ruma.
I like that about you, Nan. You only bet on a sure thing.
Naya memgem kaligam. Gegwa nam karek naya memak.
If you're with Fathra, you're dead. Simple as that.
Kremini bebe. Rapa praha vernegalek.
I knew coming here would be a good time. That's it then. Better hope your boss knows how to make a convincing forgery.
Of course. There's going to be a bloodbath once Nemro and Tothlegion see what's on the disc.
Care to explain that?
If that disc really names all of Fathra's business partners, it probably identifies half the people in Jaguna. Merchants, gangsters, debtors, the usual scum.
When Nemro gets a hold of it, he'll want revenge on anyone who dared to go to Fathra behind his back. There'll be bodies clogging the gutters for weeks.
Any particular reason I should be bothered?
Only if you plan to stick around and watch the excitement.
If you're feeling queasy, you could always erase the extra data and scratch up the disc. Make it look like only the doctored recording miraculously survived the damage. So, we deliver Keeper's forgery without the real data. Nemro doesn't get his revenge spree. The risk is that Tothlegion figures out you erased the good stuff.
I'm not endangering the mission to protect the lowlives of Hutter.
Aw, aren't we dedicated? I knew I'd learn something about you on this mission. Now let's get that thing to Tothlegion and see what happens. Hello, Tothlegion. The Red Blade claims to have something to show you.
Manchi do di puna puna, kabuk nuni slemo. Mokili mo klunky, nik mi chawa wilmo.
Turns out your suspicions were right. Fathra cut a deal with the Republic.
Tuni rana nu prata dunko? Poya tuka changa goptula do bata wana wanki. Kliska taka, ya yoska ukle yuga chesko pukuta.
Nakwa noya chioski na wiku chuzu, yo mata chitoya. Kapakonga, chisa bijamongi chikatoko.
You'll need help to stay competitive. But the Republic does have enemies. They might be useful.
Mipikasa nashura. Va fabaji. Wanda humpa. Murira bampaura.
Imache. Churon chika jiliska chanaga.
Jiliska tanana ime chaijo. Ron chika.
A pleasure doing business with you, mighty Nemro.
Jiholaguta. Ai tuta mishka.
Dobata jimoa tusawa, mikuna posta morulia.
Jibawa dolorda numa.
The deed is done, Agent. Nemro is already contacting Imperial embassies looking to establish relations. He'll be eating out of our hands within the month. In the short term, our chemical and stimulant stockpiles will nearly double. In the long term, we're a step closer to bringing all of Hutta under Imperial control. I'll make my full report to Darth Jadis shortly. I expect he'll be very pleased with our work.
That's excellent news, sir.
Your future with Imperial intelligence looks bright. But we can discuss that face to face. Your mission is now complete. There's a shuttle waiting for you in Jaguna. It will take you to Drummond Cass. Once you've arrived on planet, report to Imperial Intelligence Headquarters in the Citadel. I'll debrief you there.
Acknowledged and understood.
Khalil, you will also report to Drummond Cass. I assume Nemra won't be surprised by your sudden disappearance.
He'll be hurt, but no one will be surprised that I left with the Blade.
And he's certainly not the first employer you've walked out on. In any case, I'll expect to see both of you soon.
We're on our way.
Good. Report to the shuttle as soon as possible. Keep her out.
Atrodo normales. Smogas total gis baba apiatai.
Jeeg, I wasn't expecting to hear from you again.
Padra vimos brandimus prostis cad ataveritag. Vataranai ango mis acananon. Alas protas era.
All right. How do you suggest I respond?
Atrodo normales. Smogas total gis baba apiatai.
I appreciate the advice.
Atolgi ai parcaletiam jamas. Gratai aptite. Iruprit virtini savasia salvebe caeges.
So, you're the one who killed my men. The pretender who wants to be the Blade.
I'm no pretender. I earned my name.
You think this is a joke? I'm the Red Blade, you worm. The real Red Blade. And you've got one chance to explain yourself before I burn a hole through your head.
Hard to explain myself to a dead man.
You're a piece of work, but you're not leaving here alive. Damn you, pretender!
Commander Vassal Dawn, Special Attaché to the Ministry of Intelligence. I have 20 years combat experience, plus 12 as a garrison commander. I've spent the last decade schooling intelligence operatives. You will listen when I speak.
Paying attention now, sir.
Good woman. Knowing how to lie through your teeth or slice computer files won't keep you alive in the field. After reviewing your record, however, I'm prepared to authorize your entry into one of our combat specialization programs.
The specialization programs? How do they work?
There's a half dozen of them, revised every 10 years as new tactics and technology emerge. You're qualified for these too. You may specialize in sniping, shields and marksmanship, or stealth technology and close quarters engagement. The quartermaster will get you started.
Thank you.
Surprises me how clean you people keep your spaceports. If this were Hutta, I'd be scraping alien gunk off my boots. Of course, if this were Hutta, I couldn't be thrown into prison for spitting the wrong way. So come on, Agent. You're going to welcome me here to the Imperial homeworld?
I'm surprised you've never been here before.
I avoid Imperial space. I want to die in a cantina fight, not ticking off some bureaucrat. Anyway, let's head down to the city. Keeper wanted us to see the Citadel. I'm guessing it won't be hard to find.
Time to move, then.
Oh, absolutely.
This is not your domain, Keeper. It is mine. It has always been mine.
Of course, my lord.
All you have built here, all you hope to control, it falls apart as easily as a human life. An hour ago, the Minister of Intelligence dropped to his knees and wept before me. You would do so too, if not for fear of being humiliated.
Your dissatisfaction is clear, my lord. It will be remedied. Now I'm asking you humbly to leave. These people are suffering in your presence.
I will leave my domain at the moment of my choosing, Keeper. You, Agent, you were the one sent to Hutter. Is that correct?
That's correct, my lord.
I am Darth Jadus. You served me well in your dealings with Nemro. You will serve me well again.
It would be an honor.
Sublimate your desires to those of the Empire, and you will go far. Keeper, you will use this one. She will complete the assignment as I have instructed.
She's quite capable, my lord, but she lacks experience. A more seasoned agent.
I have made my decision. I wish the situation resolved before I leave Dromund Kaas. See to it that my will is done.
Very well. I'll make arrangements. Congratulations, Agent. You've made a friend on the Dark Council. I don't envy you.
Jade has mentioned an assignment, sir.
That's correct. I want you outfitted and ready to leave as soon as possible. Grab your equipment from the lockers and meet me in my office. Once we're through with your debriefing, we'll discuss your next mission. Come in, Agent. Let's talk. Kaleo, wait outside, please. One of the Watchers will handle your debriefing.
We need to talk about my terms.
I promise you, you'll be well compensated. You can discuss the details with the Watcher.
If you say so. You two have a good time.
So, I've been reviewing the report of your activities on Hutta. You were busier than I'd expected.
Is that a problem, sir?
That's what I'd like to figure out. You were extremely effective in your mission, and I'm impressed by your efficiency. You used violence as a tool and not a crutch. Not many agents find that balance so easily. So I wonder, why did you join Imperial Intelligence?
I joined to serve the Empire and its people.
Idealistic sentiments. A pity in some ways. You may find yourself disappointed. This isn't glamorous work. We're sanitation workers. We clean up after the military and the Sith and do the jobs no one else will. Without us, though, the Empire falls apart. So we do whatever is necessary, even if it's thankless and ugly. You understand?
I understand completely, sir.
I'm glad to hear it. Now, as to your next assignment. One of the mandates of our organization is to eliminate dissidents and terrorists within the Empire. We've located one cell of radicals here in the capital working toward the violent overthrow of our government. We must know precisely what these terrorists plan.
I assume this is the task Darth Jadus mentioned?
Although Darth Jadus has expressed concern over the cell's activities, your orders come from me. We've intercepted chatter suggesting the radicals are planning a major attack soon, but we've only identified a handful of cell members. You will investigate the cell and obtain its plans. You'll have two operatives assisting you and full support from the Citadel.
Cleo and I worked well together on Hutta. I'd like to use her again.
I think that can be arranged. Watcher 2, please come to my office. Bring Kaleo Janus with you.
Watcher 2, huh? That's a pretty name. Is it Twi'lek?
It's basic. Unlike many civilizations, the Empire teaches its children how to count. Watcher 2 reporting, sir.
Kaleo will be your aide in the field. She'll report to you and take your orders, since you seem able to handle her.
I'm making you look good, Agent. You should be grateful.
Meanwhile, Watcher 2 will be your liaison to base. She'll stay in contact remotely and provide you with mission details.
I've heard a lot about your species. Your unique skills should complement the team well.
I'll certainly do my best. So, what do you do exactly?
I analyze. I watch. I try to live up to my title.
Watcher 2 is one of our finest analysts, a success from the government eugenics programs. Her brain is faster than most computers.
Our primary lead on the Radicals is at the site of a slave rebellion beyond Kars City. You've been outfitted with all necessary equipment already. Once you're in the field, signal me via holocommunicator and I'll brief you in full.
I'll head out immediately.
Remember, you're not undercover. Identify yourself as an intelligence officer if you need to, and use the fear that it creates. You're on Imperial soil now, Agent. Welcome home.
Agent, I'm pleased to see you, of course. But I thought you'd be busy with the mission, just as well, I suppose. I'm still plotting the details. So, what can I do for you?
I figure if we're working together, we should get to know one another.
I already know all about you, though. I saw your whole performance on Hutter. If we talked and shared, you'd be the only one learning from the exchange. And that wouldn't really be fair now, would it?
We're partners now, aren't we? Doesn't that count for something?
You really want to know who I am? I'm someone bred for genetic superiority and raised to be a watcher. I enjoy my work, but I don't like getting close to my agents because they usually get killed. Now, we've both got work to do. Contact me via holocommunicator when you're on site and ready to go, okay?
We'll talk about this more another time.
Agreed. Goodbye, Agent.
Jutaki mem panino. Am kabina pek mem no kimgam. Unuk inu mem no. Am kakam mem perolak palak.
You're the only other alien I've seen in Imperial Intelligence.
Raga memua inu bunyan. Kemapa am kanamia. Manuk marakanaja.
I don't intend to disappoint anyone.
Hakamalam aku pergi ke kama memua pengguana kumia yang mem gamba paka.
You're the new alien, eh? Well, let's see how that works out. I'm Fixer 12. Used to be a field operative, but these days, I keep this place running.
Why'd you stop working in the field?
Wasn't by choice. I was a good agent until a Jedi shoved a lightsaber through my lungs. That service. That sacrifice. People here will tell you that the Sith interfere with our work. Keep us always fighting with the Minister of Intelligence, that sort of thing. Maybe they're right, but it doesn't matter. Our job's to obey orders. Our job's to deal with the enemy.
You're absolutely right.
Then you can consider me a friend. Imperial Intelligence needs more agents like you. I need to get back to duty. But remember our talk. You have potential.
I'll try to keep it all in mind.
Good choice. Be careful out there.
Oh, hello. Sorry, I didn't expect you to come over. You're the field agent from Hutter, right? I'm Watcher 3.
Pleasure to meet you, Watcher 3.
And you? Watcher 2 said you'd been performing admirably, especially for a junior agent. Not that I mean any disrespect, I'm not one to talk about seniority here. I've only been Watcher 3 for 6 months. Surprised I even got a Watcher designation. If I can manage it, I'm sure you'll get a title soon.
How many Watchers are there, anyway?
Only Keeper knows for sure. I've never met a Watcher with a designation higher than 4. Watcher 1's on assignment right now, so it's just me and Watcher 2 here. Anyway, I should get back to work. I'm on surveillance duty and I don't want to miss anything.
Good man. Make sure that you don't.
Of course. I won't keep you.
Watcher 2 here. I'm receiving your signal. Mapping your location now. Glad you made it through the jungle safely, Agent. Ready to work?
I'm ready. Just standing by for the details.
You may have noticed the chaos out there. There's a slave rebellion going on and you're heading into the middle of it. Our analyst charged with monitoring the rebellion is with me. His name is Lodenth Kashar. He can fill you in on the details.
Nikak aga kik nebam. Naya amga maraka ki.
Go ahead then.
Jukaki mem paninu. Am kapina bek mem no kimgam. Blaka kalam kala. Nimiak orabagyan migik.
Imperial intelligence is leaving concerns about the rebellion itself to the military. You're here for a specific slave, an alien named Jurithus.
I can extract him. What's his story?
Jurithus was once owned by an anti-government radical who used slaves to carry messages to like-minded dissidents.
Have we questioned the slave's former master?
He's gone. Dead at the hands of an over-enthusiastic agent. That's why Minder 4 is no longer with us.
One way or another, I'll make sure he talks.
Another reason why it's useful to have aliens on staff. In any case, good luck.
I'll get Jurithus' messages.
You should find your targets inside the camp. Take a slave down, apply the serum, and locate Jurithus. This is the only way we can learn what the radicals are planning. Time's running out, Agent.
I'm running. Chest hurts. Something's in my head. Rain's coming down. Everything's sinking into the ground.
Potent stuff. Haven't seen anyone zoned out like that since Nar Shaddaa.
I think I know you, but I don't remember anything. I don't know what you want. Everything hurts.
I'm looking for someone. Can you help me?
I can help you. Let me help you. I don't know what to do with my head. Please tell me.
Obey me. Tell me about Jurithus.
Jurithus is gone. Day is gone now. It all goes so slowly. Jurithus burns and starts to look like our Colossus. Incomplete. Jurithus died fighting in the jungle. I don't remember why we were fighting. Jurithus died, I know that.
Do you know where he kept his belongings?
He kept his old life with him. Strange life, strange data pads. He thought they were valuable. Jurithus died with Sathan and Raneth and Avoira. All aliens. All friends. All fighting beside the foot of the statue. Jurithus is still there. If the beasts haven't eaten him.
I'll check the pile of alien corpses then. Shouldn't be too hard to find.
What should I think about now? I don't know what to do with my head. I don't know what to do with my hands.
It's time to stop fighting. Go surrender yourself to the troops.
The troops? I don't know why I fought them. I'm going to them.
Guess he didn't have much dignity. But I wouldn't want to be him when he wakes up.
Laboram amga, mangi nikan, nag naya mangi kamgam, naya nam ramkam, kala amkam mani mani, libik bak.
Do you have any updates for me?
Manuk maraka naja, ki namabam, yak manala, nimgam gam gi nia giguan, amner nahanak.
Put me through.
Ignayan minka.
Agent, you're to suspend all field operations immediately. You're needed elsewhere.
Needed for what, sir?
An urgent matter. Darth Jadis wants to speak with you. You will proceed to his chambers for an audience. You've met Darth Jadis, experienced his power. I suggest you treat him with respect and do as he asks.
Yes, sir. I'll keep that in mind.
For what it's worth, I tried to shield you from this, but it seems it was unavoidable. You will resume operations when this is finished, Agent. Keep her out.
Well, that didn't sound so good. Still, powerful men are the same across the galaxy. I'll bet your life that whatever else Jadis is, he's a powerful man too.
You stand in the chambers of Darth Jadis, Lord of the Dark Council.
the Ratataki must remain outside. The Master has not requested her presence.
Looks like I'll have to miss this one then. Real shame.
I'll meet you when we're done in here.
Sure thing, Agent.
Come, stand before me, and revel in the power of the Dark Council. Allow your body to betray you. Allow your blood to boil and your heart to slow. Everything that is not of the dark side will be purged, or it will be tainted. This is inoculation, Agent. This is a sacred rite. You are privileged.
It is an honor, my lord.
It has been earned. This is your due reward. You proved yourself by outmaneuvering the Hearts. Now I choose you to exterminate the dissidents who would destroy our way of life. I sense your uncertainty. You wonder why I involve myself in this affair. Why I take an interest in you and Imperial intelligence.
As you say.
Many in the Dark Council hold themselves above the mundane business of the Empire. I believe this is a mistake. I believe we must spread the ways of the Sith to the Empire entire. Plant terror and hatred in every heart. I believe in the democratization of fear. But these dissidents threaten all progress. Left unchecked, they would reduce our world to ash and raise nothing in its place.
What do they want, aside from the destruction of the Empire?
They want what children want. Unlimited freedom without responsibility. This makes them no less dangerous. Do not underestimate our enemies. They are powerful. And there are those who sympathize with them, people at the highest levels of government. I chose you for this assignment, not only because of your successes, but because you are an outsider, an alien whom your superiors disdain and overlook. Your loyalty is uncompromised.
I believe I understand, my lord.
Good. Watch those around you, and trust no one. I will leave Dromund Kaas soon aboard the starship Dominator. I will travel with 1,000 dignitaries, diplomats, and slaves, and show them the galaxy as I envision it. When I return, I expect the dissidents to have been purged. Kneel before me now, and I will ensure that you have the means to succeed.
I kneel before you, my lord.
I have remade the pitiful creatures around you into my image. So shall I remake you into the vessel for my power. Now go from here, and return to your duties.
I've learned a great deal. Thank you for this audience.
Remember what I have said. Remember that you walk the path to power. And remember that I am eternal.
I'm here. What's the situation?
This is Watcher 2. We're still working on full analysis of the slaves' files, but we have a new lead. Proceed to the Nexus Room Cantina in Kaas City. I'll brief you once you're in place.
I'll be there shortly. Anything else?
Just make sure you're ready to socialize. Watcher 2 out. This is Watcher 2, signal established. I've tapped into the Cantina Holocams, Agent. I can see you from 6 different angles. We're ready to go.
Give me the rundown.
So, Theovor Mindak is a genius inventor and entrepreneur working with the Radicals. Unfortunately, Theovor is being sheltered by the Sith Lord Grathan. Grathan turns a blind eye to Theovor's affiliations in exchange for weapon designs.
Can't we demand that Grathan turn him over? Supporting dissidents is treason.
Dealing with Grathan directly isn't an option. He's involved in a power struggle with the other Dark Lords. In essence, he's gone rogue. However, Theovor's daughter, Samara, frequents this cantina. She has access to Theovor's workshop in Gratham's estate.
I'll talk to her. What's her profile?
Samara Mindak is rich, young, and willing to flaunt her advantages. She's popular with the Kaas City elite, but hardly beloved. No meaningful connections or reputation. Our profile suggests she'll cooperate if given incentives. I've located her in a private lounge. It's up to you how to handle her.
She won't be a problem.
Once Samara's told you how to reach her father's workshop, head to Lord Grathan's estate. Send us anything you find on Theovor's computers.
Consider it done.
Go. I'll be watching.
What good are Mandalorians if they can't escort a few trade shipments? It's not like we need them for the war.
Stop obsessing about the mercenaries, Oban. You wish you could carry a Vira blade.
You get vicious after a while, don't you?
Sure. I'm going to go talk to someone else now.
She's a brat, but she's got spirit. Want to break it?
And look at you. Enjoying yourself? Not the worst party I've ever been to. But it needs improvement, you know?
I know what you mean. But things are looking up now.
Yeah, I guess. A military girl's allowed to have a good time.
You are military, right?
Not a lot of aliens walk in here without a chaperone. I figure you've got to be very special.
I'm not military. I'm from Imperial Intelligence.
I see. You're going to make me mysteriously disappear.
Samara, be careful. You need to take this seriously.
Shut up, Oban. I said I'm done with you.
So, tell me, how can I serve the Empire?
You can get me inside Theovor Mindak's workshop. The Empire expects your cooperation.
I think a chill just ran up my spine.
Okay. I didn't realize it had gotten that serious with him. Never liked Dad much anyway.
You can have my access codes. They'll get you inside Theovor's space at Lord Grathen's estate. Probably into some of his storage units too. You'll need a key card, but the guards carry those. I usually just ask someone to swipe me through.
Your assistance will be remembered.
Look, I don't need trouble. I'd rather throw my lot in with you than with my dad. So we're square, right?
We're finished here. Stay out of trouble.
Fine. I have a party to get back to. I really don't need to know any details about what you're up to.
I don't have any business with you.
You thought you could take me by surprise, but you can't.
What do you want to bet this ends badly?
Those were my daughter's access codes you used. Whatever you've done to her, I'll have my revenge.
Calm down, Theovor. Your daughter is fine.
Fine? Imperial Intelligence doesn't leave people fine. You people took away my wife, stole her from my house one night, and never told me what happened. My only daughter grew up to be worthless, and now you've taken her from me too. I despise your kind.
We can resolve this peacefully, if you'll just listen to me.
No, there won't be any peace until the Empire changes its ways.
This is Watcher 2. I'm downloading the contents of Theovor's computers. Looks like blueprints, work he's done for Lord Grathen, and... encrypted files. I should be able to decipher them if I cross-reference with the slave's datapad. Don't like what I'm seeing. There's a timetable, activity convergences, indications of something big. Get back to base as soon as you can.
I'll head there immediately.
I'll see you soon, Agent. Watcher 2 out.
Watcher 3, I need that link up to the Dominator. If Lord Jadis wishes to observe, we must accommodate him.
Establishing Hololink, sir. Data flow is synchronized.
Glad you found the time to pay us a visit, Agent. Take your place. The briefing starts now.
Yes, sir.
Lord Jadis, are you receiving our transmission?
I am. Proceed, Keeper.
Very well. You all know we've been attempting to determine the Dissident's plan of attack. Thanks to recent operations, we have the information we need. Unfortunately, the news is worse than we expected. A major strike is imminent. The Dissidents are targeting the ancient power conduits that run beneath the capital.
Their intention is to overload the power grid, causing a cascade failure that would detonate the power relay stations. The resulting explosions would kill hundreds of people, and the blackout would leave us vulnerable to further attacks.
Sir, aren't all access points to the power grid under military control?
All but one. The terrorists intend to access the power conduits through the Dark Temple. I'll sum up for those of you unfamiliar with the history. The Dark Temple predates Drummond Kasa's colonization. It was sealed by the Sith during the city's construction. When the Dark Council opened it some months back, they found it inhabited by force-driven phenomena. Workers on site began disappearing inside, controlled by unknown entities.
But whereas we saw the Dark Temple as a threat to be contained, the Dissidents saw it as an opportunity. The Temple rests directly above a key power junction. If the Dissidents can push past the, phenomena, they can access the grid.
These Dissidents have been planning. They have supplies, maps, and weapons, and they're not counting on making it out alive. This is a suicide run.
That won't make things easy. They'll only fight harder.
We have security footage of Dissidents heading toward the Dark Temple. A full squad of operatives will pursue the...
No.
My lord?
There will be no squad. The Dark Temple is sacred ground and will not be unduly disturbed. My agent will go alone.
I'll make sure the job is done.
My lord, I strongly urge you to reconsider. If the Dissidents succeed, we...
The spirits of the Temple must not be disturbed. Not by terrorists, and not by Imperial intelligence. One agent will suffice. My role here is finished. Do as I will, Keeper.
Very well. Then the decision is made. You will go to the Dark Temple, stop the Radicals from reaching the conduits and detonating their charges.
Let's get this done.
Good woman.
We'll monitor you as long as we can, but the Temple blocks most transmissions, so just, good luck, Agent.
If I survive, you're buying the drinks.
It's a deal.
Go on, Agent. The Dark Temple is waiting.
Are you with the military? I heard the shots, but I wasn't sure. I can't believe you actually followed us in here. None of us are gonna make it back out, you know that, right?
Don't question me, you piece of filth.
You think you've done some great thing by tracking me down? You can shoot me now. You can save the power grid, preserve the Imperial lifestyle for a little longer. But there are other cells. They'll keep fighting.
Time's up. You're dead.
You'll never make it out in here, Imperial.
We've got wreckage coming down over the city. From that height and at that velocity, the collateral damage alone could cost millions.
If the reactor core was breached, the radiation damage will...
I don't care about the radiation damage, dammit. Get me security footage, communications logs, something we can use.
Shouldn't someone be celebrating our successful return?
All military channels are reporting in. The Dominator has been completely destroyed.
What's the situation?
It's good to see you. There was a secondary target. Apparently...
Watcher 2, I still need confirmation. And you, Agent, get ready to move. We need everyone operational.
Sorry, sir. But there were over 3,000 people on that ship, half of them civilians.
I'm aware of that. Do your job, Watcher 2. Run the numbers.
Lockdown procedures are in place. All traffic has been grounded.
Initial analysis is done. Cross-checking with the droids.
Getting conflicting reports from the Car City spaceport. Trying to sort it out.
Nothing could have survived that explosion. All sources confirm casualties are 100%.
Then Darth Jadis is dead.
Who did this? What happened?
There was an explosion aboard the Dominator. We're not sure about the origin, but it has to be connected to the Dissidents. Darth Jadis was leaving on a special tour of the Empire. He brought military personnel, civilians, and Sith to his flagship as part of some grand vision. Now they're all dead.
We'll catch the terrorists responsible.
You can count on it.
Sir, we've got a starship trying to take off. Several Dissidents from the watch list are aboard. Military squads are moving to intervene.
They'll blow the ship to pieces. I want the terrorists alive and I want their computer intact. You, Fixer, do we have any SecM units available?
What? I don't...
The SecMs, the mouse droids. Find one and bring it back now.
Whatever ordeal you went through in the Dark Temple, your recovery will have to wait. I need you in the field.
I'm ready to go, sir.
One moment. Fixer!
I have the droid here.
Good. Agent, I need you to get to the city cargo port. There's a terrorist ship attempting to take off. Take the mouse droid and deliver it into one of the ship's maintenance conduits. With the droid aboard, we can disable the hyperdrive and download its computer contents.
We're going too easy on them, Keeper.
We'll use a tractor beam to bring in their disabled ship, at which point they'll get their due, I promise. Get going. We need you to plant that mouse droid. Any conduit on the ship's outer hull should do. And when you're back, we have things to discuss. Welcome back, Agent. Excellent work out there. Absolutely excellent.
The mouse droid has just sent the contents of the ship's computer, sir. I'll send the military to pick up the dissident.
At least one thing's gone smoothly today. The worst seems to have passed, but don't expect to rest anytime soon.
I'll be ready when you need me.
I know, and you will be needed. With Jadis dead, there'll be a mad rush to fill the power vacuum. We'll be fending off our own people with one hand and tracking down terrorists with the other.
Keeper, I'm receiving a transmission. Someone's broadcasting a holo recording to the entire Imperial Communications Network.
The terrorists want to talk. I'd say we should listen.
Patching it through now. I'm going to try to pinpoint the source.
Citizens of the Empire, this is the Eagle. I'm here to tell you that our government is corrupt. When the Emperor signed his treaty with the Galactic Republic, we were promised a new epoch. Glory unrivaled since the first Sith dynasty. Instead, our empire has suffered. Apathetic moths and wicked lords of the Dark Council vie for power, while our soldiers die over worthless planets in nameless star systems.
Typical consolidationist rhetoric. Watcher 2, keep trying to find a source for the broadcast. Everyone else, start pulling up our files on the Eagle.
Any idea what he wants?
Power. Whatever political agenda he's espousing, whatever reforms his followers want, what he's really after is power.
Anyone who speaks out in favor of reform is kidnapped and tortured by Imperial intelligence. This must not continue.
The Ministry of Logistics reports that they can't jam the signal. Everyone in the Empire is seeing this.
A short while ago, a group of defiant revolutionaries destroyed an Imperial dreadnought. 3,000 people were aboard, including Darth Jadis, a Lord of the Dark Council. We chose to strike at Darth Jadis publicly so that every Imperial citizen would know the truth. The Dark Council is not invulnerable. We can affect change. We regret the sacrifice of so many civilians, but it was necessary. The Empire cannot cover up this momentous event. Imperial intelligence cannot silence our call to arms.
Get to the point, you piece of filth. What is it you really want to say?
What do you mean?
Here it comes.
This is only the first step towards a better future. We have agents throughout the Empire preparing to strike again and again. We will not relent until our government chooses strength over weakness, unity over discord. We will continue to show the anger of the people. This is the Eagle. End transmission.
So, our enemy has a name. You think you can deal with that, Agent?
It won't be a problem, sir.
Glad to hear it. We've made mistakes today. We underestimated the Eagle. We were too slow to eliminate the dissidents. We assumed the Dark Temple was the sole terrorist target. But you performed above and beyond expectations. You showed you can handle these people, and now you're going to show us the way forward.
I followed my orders, that's all.
You followed them well. That's discouragingly rare. You are going to head our operation to dismantle the Eagle's network. You will locate and eliminate his terror cells through infiltration, manipulation, and assassination. I am assigning you a rank and designation as suits your new position. You no longer have a name. You will answer only to Cipher 9.
I promise, you won't regret this.
Congratulations, Cipher 9. You earned this.
Cipher 9, huh? Cute. But I think I'll keep calling you Agent.
With the rank come certain privileges, including a degree of operational independence. You may recruit your own operatives and you will be outfitted with a starship. Watcher 2, you will remain Cipher 9's liaison to base. I assume that won't be a problem.
No problem, sir. Glad to stay a part of this operation.
Good. Begin analyzing all reports on recent dissident activity. I want a list of possible terror cell locations within the hour. The Eagle says he's got agents around the galaxy. Assuming he's telling the truth, you're going to be doing some traveling.
I'm looking forward to it.
I thought you might. Your starship is at the spaceport. It's been refit and removed from public record. Watcher 2 will upload likely activity centers for the Eagle and his network. Proceed to your targets as you see fit.
We'll have our revenge. The terrorists will pay for everything that's happened.
Be careful of these people, Cipher. Destroying the Dominator was no mean feat. Killing Darth Jadis was nearly unthinkable. But this is our job. Do whatever is required. And good luck.
Cipher 9. It's going to be a while before I'm used to saying that. Looks like we've got a moment of calm. How are you handling everything?
Managing.
But I'm ready for whatever's next. I'm glad to hear it. Look, I apologize if I seem short with you before. The situation with the Dominator shook me. How is it that I can torture a colleague without feeling a thing? But 3,000 dead strangers is too much to handle?
After what's happened, it sounds like a normal reaction to me.
I suppose there's some small comfort in that. Thank you. Anyway, I shouldn't bother you with this. I've been monitoring you for too long. I'm starting to think of you as a friend instead of our alien agent.
If we're friends, we're friends. Just because I'm not human doesn't mean we can't get along.
I appreciate that. It takes some getting used to, that's all. But thank you. It's been a long day, and I've still got to send our reports to the Minister of Intelligence. I'm sure you have plenty to do yourself.
I've got an Eagle to catch.
Whatever you need to make that happen, just ask.
Good to see you back, Cipher 9.
Your ship is waiting, Cipher. Time to leave.
I am 2VR8, factotum droid for this vessel. You must be my new master. Gentle, kind new master.
A gift from my superior. Here to keep an eye on me, I presume.
My only directive is your satisfaction, master. Besides, my photoreceptors are not surveillance grade. I am programmed for a wide array of tasks, including but not limited to meal preparation, ship maintenance, janitorial duty, and etiquette. Welcome aboard the X-70B Phantom, an experimental prototype resembling a luxury shuttle that conceals the combat capabilities of a heavy starfighter. You'll find all of the standard amenities, including your own private captain's locker for storing valuables. The astrogation console contains a constantly updated map of the known galaxy. Interstellar communications are accessed via the ship's holoterminal. Priority alerts that you may find useful are available from the Imperial Holonet console. Lastly, the ship's intercom will inform your crew that you wish to issue new orders. Any questions, Master?
I have a mission to complete. Time to see what this ship can do.
Thank goodness you aren't deactivating me. I mean, good luck. I regret I am unable to offer you combat support, Master. Frankly, my chassis couldn't withstand the stress. However, should any errands arise that are beneath your superior status, please do not hesitate to call upon me. I function to serve you. Whenever you are ready to depart, consult the galaxy map on your bridge. It will program the proper astrogation coordinates and activate the engines.
Nice digs.
Think you got a message on that thing.
Download and begin playback.
Cipher 9, intelligence is finalizing your target list, but in the meantime, there's a formality we need to address. With Darth Jadis' demise, his seat on the Dark Council has opened. It will be filled by his daughter and sole apprentice, Darth Jorid.
Jadis has a daughter?
Lord Jorid demands to meet with you. Proceed to Korriban at once. She has authorized your presence in the Sith Academy.
Find a seat. We leave immediately.
Give me a shout if you need something. I'm gonna see how they stock the lounge.
Look who made it all the way to Korriban. I think we have a visitor.
Yes, my lord.
Commander, I want to be informal with my bodyguards.
Yes, Lady Jorid.
Delightful. You, my pretty alien. Don't you find my bodyguards delightful?
Absolutely delightful, my lord.
Excellent. Delightful bodyguard, I have a request.
Yes, my lady?
Kill our visitor, please.
As you wish. She's as good as dead.
Oh, wonderful. My poor bodyguards.
I'm starting to get a little peeved. And a little creeped out.
We haven't been introduced. I'm Darth Jorid, Lord of the Dark Council and successor to Darth Jadis. I hear you're investigating my father's assassination. I wanted to see if you were worthy.
The attack was a test, then.
I could sense your feelings during the fight. I think you'll do nicely tracking these terrorists. But are you really sure that this eagle killed the mighty Darth Jadis?
Why do you ask?
Because I thought you might know more than your superiors. Jadis believed in spreading fear and anger to every planet and species in the Empire. Even to creatures like you. Perhaps his ambitions drew too much attention. Any one of his rivals on the Dark Council might have killed him.
If you're right, you're the next obvious target.
You're so kind to be concerned. Chase after your terrorists. Save the lives of your Imperial friends, but if you learn who's really responsible, come to me. I've earned my place on the Dark Council, and I won't share my father's fate. Dismissed.
This is Cipher 9 to headquarters. Do you have my target list?
Watcher 2 here. I've finished preliminary mapping of the Eagle's network. Your designated targets are terror cells located on Balmora near the Republic border and on Nar Shaddaa in Hutt space.
I'll contact you once I've arrived. Cipher 9 out.
Acknowledged. Watcher 2 out.
What's the situation?
Manuk Maraganaja, Ki Nawabam, Yakmanala. Kam Inu Memnu, Naja Naya Ankam Mimik Meraga.
Tell me why not?
Laboram Anga, Mamni Nikan, Nagnaya Mamni Kamgam, Rujagak, Yang Kim Aliam.
Sorry about that, Cipher 9. Welcome to the Eastern Galactic Front. This whole star system is a crisis point. Republic and Empire are testing one another's strength. Meanwhile, the terrorists lurk in the middle.
It's a perfect place to operate, isn't it?
Exactly right. The Eagle's men are using the war as a cover for local activities. Balmora is their training ground. Cell members recruit, instruct, and arm new terrorists here. Fresh soldiers destined for other points in the network. It's a vital part of the system.
So, where do I sign up to join?
That I can't tell you, but you have the right idea. To dismantle the terror cell there, you'll need local support. I'm alerting one of our officials to your presence. Lucerne Renald is the station chief in Sobrick, the Imperial settlement where you landed. He runs intelligence operations on Balmora and can brief you more thoroughly.
What's your assessment of the man?
He's worked for us for decades. I've never met him, but I expect he's loyal. Renald runs his affairs out of the back of an arms dealership. He'll be waiting for you when you arrive. Move quickly on this one, Cipher 9, and watch what you say. If things go bad, you'll have half a planet gunning for you.
Well, what have we here? Let me take a look at you. Splendid! No one ever suspects an alien. I'm glad Keeper finally sent someone. Pity it took a disaster to get headquarters' attention.
You must be Station Chief Reynold.
At your service. I've been assigned to Balmora for almost 20 years and haven't enjoyed a day of it. Ha! But here, I'm being a poor host. Have a drink. Settle in after your trip. This shop doesn't look like much, but it's secure.
Let's get to the point.
You're reminding me of Keeper already. Very well. This terror cell you're after, worse than the Republic, homegrown. They use bombings and sabotage to show their distaste for Imperial rule. Punishing the civilian population doesn't seem to deter them, but if we can take out the local leader, the cell should fall apart.
You have this plan, but you haven't actually implemented it.
Yes, well, we don't know exactly who the leader is. The terrorists call the man in charge Grey Star. He runs the cell, gives the orders, and knows all the secrets. They claim Grey Star used to work with the Eagle, but who can be sure? Only the high-ranking cell members know Grey Star's identity.
It's a complication, but there's opportunity there.
I have a mole inside the terrorist cell already. He's a good lad. No cipher, though. He can bring you in. You'd have the opportunity to impress the terrorists, win their trust.
And gain access to their leader.
Precisely. Grey Star will be ours. Sanju Pine, my operative, can introduce you to the terrorist recruiters at the Troida Military Workshop outside the safe zone. But be careful how you present yourself. If the terrorists suspect you're Imperial, you'll lose Grey Star. And your lives.
Don't waste my time, Sanju. You're lucky to even be here.
I got you those scramblers, didn't I? Come on, Kimish, you owe me. Maybe not big time, but you owe me.
When's the last time you did an operation for us?
What? Come on, we've been over this.
Grey Star didn't send out a call for cowards, and neither did the Eagle. Do you think...
Hey! Someone finally made it. It's great to meet you in person. This is the group I was telling you about. I think you'll get along with them real well. Better than I do, hopefully.
I've been looking forward to meeting your friends.
Kimish, this is the woman who got in touch with me after the Eagle's broadcast. Said she wanted to join us.
Uh-huh. Sanju says you fought the Imperials at Druckenwell. Says the Empire has a bounty on your head.
I didn't know you were at Druckenwell. We should talk.
Is all that real? You some ace killer looking to get the Empire off Balmora?
You think I don't live up to my reputation?
Maybe I do. Can you blame me? My name's Kamish. These people here, they follow Greystar, our founder. They've been spat on, starved, and punished by the Empire. Now you... You're not from Balmora. You haven't been through what they've been through. Makes me wonder how far I can trust you.
You don't have to trust me. Let me prove myself.
Maybe I'll do that. Maybe you can impress Grey Star. There's an abandoned factory not far from here. Used to make droids, but its defenses went haywire when the Empire took over. Place is swarming with rogue security units. It's also full of expensive equipment. Get inside, and there's something I want.
Name it, and it's yours.
The Okara Droid Factory produced shielded power cores for stealth droids. I want a case for my people. My people can convert the cores into explosives, plant them around an enemy base, and thanks to the stealth shielding, no one will know until it's too late.
As soon as you say the word, I can be on my way.
Let's be upfront. This is a test. So if you fail, don't bother coming back. We'll just kill you.
Good luck, and be careful. The factory's a nasty place.
Thank the stars I reached you. Sorry about earlier. With Kimish there, I couldn't say a thing. Station Chief Reynold told me you were from Imperial Intelligence, so I set things up as fast as I could. Anyway, Sanju Pine. Guess you know that.
What's the situation?
So... Kimish verified your background. Intelligence did its job, you're fine there. I'm doing my best to find out anything about the cell leader, Grey Star. Maybe you can learn more when Kimish trusts you.
Winning over Kimish is the top priority.
Right. Well, she's a fanatic, but she respects results. The more you impress her, the more she'll give. There's one other thing. Those power cores you're after? You know what Kimish plans to do with them, right? She's gonna attack Sobrek. She'll have some of the new recruits plant the bombs and run, hit the town and the Imperial base.
That's very nearly sickening.
I know a way to disable the power core so Kimish won't suspect you. There's a machine in the factory that can do it. Run the sealed case through the machine, and the cores will fry. Kimish will see you didn't unlock it. She'll assume the cores went bad over the years.
It's a risk, but we could save a lot of people. I'm in.
Great. We'll send you the machine's coordinates. We can stop a lot of bloodshed. I'll see you when you get back to Troida, okay? Send you out.
Kinda cute, isn't he? Kinda stupid, too. If he had money, he'd be perfect.
If you want him, he's yours.
Anyone I want is mine. It's one of my charms. But I don't want Sanju. Anyway, let's find that machine. Or maybe not.
Back already? Your friend's quick, Sanju.
Told you she was good.
You tell me a lot of things, but I asked for the stealth droid power cores. If you don't have them, you're wasting my time.
Right here, Kimish. The full crate. All yours.
Huh. Looks like you actually made it to the factory.
It'll take a minute to get this case open. Sanju, go fetch Pyther and a droid.
I think we've got it, Kimish. Crack the case open and let's see if our new friend did the job right.
Looks like everything's here. Except... what's this?
The readouts say the power cores are fried. What did you do?
That case was sitting there for a long time. Looks like the power core is decayed.
It is suspicious. But power cores are pretty fragile.
Yeah. Okay. Bad luck can happen to anyone. Once.
You said yourself that you need people. Let me try again.
Fine. I'll give you one more shot, but you better make this work.
You've seen the caves in this valley? Dark and cramped, but they make a nice hiding place. Scanners bounce right off them.
Useful for all sorts of things.
Seems like a good discovery. Greystar set up a training outpost in the caves a while back. Then the Empire started dropping gas bombs on the Republic. The outpost was poisoned. Toxin got into the soil. Turned good kids into drooling psychos. And the caves were overrun by our own people.
You said it was a training outpost? What kind of training outpost?
Place we took angry recruits and taught them how to shoot a blaster or use a stim pack. Nothing fancy. We're willing to cut our losses, but there's still data on the outpost computers. I want it transmitted out and the systems destroyed.
Sanju, get to high ground outside of town. You can pick up the signal with the booster box.
Is all that clear? The toxin victims will be after you, but get that data wiped, or we're finished.
I know what I'm doing. I'll make it through the caves.
Now get out of here. I've got to figure out what we're gonna do without those power cores.
Receiving your transmission. Give me a second to fine-tune the frequency and I'll start transferring the data. There. It's all coming in now. I guess you made it to the outpost, okay?
I'm fine. What's your status?
I'm in the grasslands above the valley. Kimish didn't send anyone with me so I can speak freely. It's actually really pretty up here. All this data Kimish wanted us to retrieve. I think some of it's from Greystar. Orders, communiques, all sorts of stuff. Blast. There's a list of collaborators. Balmorans who've been working with the Empire since the occupation. Kimish hates collaborators.
You think this is what she was after?
I'd bet on it. Kimish probably wants to make the list public. If the collaborators are outed, a lot of Balmorans will want them dead. Some of these guys are officials, factory bosses, the works. If they start getting killed, the governor's gonna punish everyone.
If we don't give Kimish the data, she can't cause trouble. Problem solved.
No good. She already knows the list is here, but I have an idea. Look, I can send the list on to the Imperial authorities. They can set up protection for the collaborators in case Kimish goes public. I know Kimish might get suspicious after what happened with the power cores, but what else can we do?
We have to maintain our cover at all costs, even if that means people get killed.
I was afraid you'd say that. I won't do anything, as per your orders. I need to sign off and get back to Troida. You should do the same. Send you out.
How could you hurt his feelings? He respects you so much, and you were cruel to him. All he wanted was to save a few lives. Now how will you two ever find happiness together? The poor boy's crushed.
I'm really not interested in him. Let's leave it at that.
Sanju will never know what he's missed. Let's get going, huh?
So you made it back. You did good work out there. All the data's intact. Did Sanju tell you those computers had a list of Imperial collaborators? You helped us expose traitors.
They're the worst kind of scum. I hope they get what they deserve.
They will. I can pretty much promise that. You know, you had me worried when those power cores didn't work. I'm still not sure what to make of you. But you're doing all right. And I need your skills for a special job. I don't have anyone else who can handle it.
Just say the word, Kemish. I'm in.
You know all about the way the Empire and the Republic have been using our planet as a battleground. Pretty obvious stuff. Normally, the Republic doesn't bother us. They've got other worries. But I need someone to get inside the main Republic base.
It won't be simple, but you've come to the right person.
Good attitude. I need you to make a drop to one of our friends in the Republic ranks. Get past the guards, get inside and make the delivery. That's it.
I guess I'll just have to trust you.
Here's the package and the coordinates of your target. He'll know what to do once you make the delivery. We're clearing out this safe house, so I'll contact you once we've settled somewhere else. And be careful at the base. They find you, they kill you.
Believe me, I can handle a few soldiers.
See you in a while. If you make it back alive, I can promise we'll be working together a lot.
We'll talk soon. Watch yourself.
Hey, I don't have long, but please tell me you didn't deliver the package to the Republic base yet.
I haven't delivered the package yet.
Then I have good news. That package you're carrying is for Greystar, the terror cell leader. Greystar's the man inside the Republic base. Kemish wants to extract him, and you've been sent to help.
If you're right, then Greystar is mine.
That's how it looks. As best I can tell, Greystar has been secretly managing and supplying the terror cell while pretending to be a loyal Republic officer. It was the perfect cover. Well, until the Republic started to suspect. Now, Greystar needs to escape before he's caught.
He's not going anywhere. I can promise that.
Well, maybe, but there's something else. Your package contains instructions and maps leading to a safe house. But we could change those instructions. Send Greystar into a trap. Once we have Greystar, we could make him give up his security protocols. We could send out orders to the cell using his name.
In that case, the Empire would have the whole cell as a puppet.
That's the idea. I know how Kemish and her people think. If we capture Greystar and learn what he knows, I can forge convincing orders. Chief Reynolds has been looking for a way to turn the terrorists against the Republic for ages. We can make it work.
You're trickier than I thought, Sanju.
I'm sending you rendezvous coordinates. If you want to do this thing, tell Greystar to meet me there. I'll arrange the rest. If you don't send him my way, well, I guess you'll have to kill him.
You have anything else for me?
I don't know if I'll see you again. Depending on what happens with Greystar, I may have to go into hiding for a while. But it's been an honor working with you. Sanju, out.
Vertvoli drafa ut porta mina. Menufitan fine mil mamorio matumiten. Eruele flara garo, is aborgesem ze vaxa inatro. Bome finadre.
A woman named Kemish sent me here. You know who I'm talking about.
Imarne am pasagir fir hog bruor. Pegarus plot as vista bokar pina nui marstro deber kur burkuni.
I'm proud to have done my part. I'll do anything to set Balmora free.
Koniski lefi skazanum. Iru atiroloi arom bruabo. Ah, skoribo for emitia dosium. Mo flaska ki kafi mamogur tu flator.
There has been a change of plans. You're going to rendezvous with one of our people at these coordinates.
Dau van Mordlegar, hiels trioio furgalugar. Hefskam bimio helka tüdverk, Hever zegna ek jou op vlok, kompa. Ek gratio per god huska me vini. Mina mu forksa me ohun.
I'll remember that, sir.
Bauer daru vonar. Uva pori e bil skure e au gut, dar nu dar glangar.
I expect a full report as soon as possible, Station Chief.
Of course. As soon as things have calmed down. Ha! What have we here? If it isn't the Cypher herself, come triumphantly to our doorstep. I was just telling our keeper about you.
Am I interrupting a meeting?
No, we were finishing up. Reynold, summarize the situation for Cypher 9.
You gave us quite a prize, Cypher. The Terra cell under our control. Greystar captured and replaced by Sanju Pine, of all people. I never dreamed we'd see such success, but Sanju has already begun sending orders, and the terrorists now unwittingly serve us.
Now that the cell's under your control, how do you intend to use it?
For the time being, Sanju will use the Greystar persona to gather information and turn the terrorists against the Republic.
As time goes on, we may find other uses for the terrorists, but that's another discussion. The Balmoran cell is no longer a threat. The other cells in the Eagle's network will no longer receive fresh recruits and supplies from this world.
Then the operation was successful.
That's correct. Station Chief Reynold will take matters from here. He'll run cleanup and forward any discoveries to headquarters. When you return to your ship, contact Watcher 2. She will brief you on all new developments and transfer credits to your discretionary accounts.
I'll be on my way shortly.
Good work once again, Cypher 9. Keeper out.
That man hides it well, but the strain's getting to him. Probably worried the Dark Council will skin him alive.
He looked fine to me. You're just imagining things.
Make no mistake, I don't hold him responsible for what happened, but Darth Jadis was assassinated on his watch. Oh, but now's no time to discuss politics. You deserve a moment of celebration, and I have work to do.
I'll let you get to it, then.
Safe journey, young Cypher.
Not bad, Agent. Not bad at all. You and me, we're going places.
Transmission established. This is Watcher 2. I'm glad you checked in, Cypher. Chatter has increased among the surviving cells, and it seems the Eagle is planning another attack.
What kind of attack?
I'm not sure. The Eagle only needed one cell to bomb the Dominator and assassinate Darth Jadis. For what's coming, he's using the entire Terra network. But the messages we've intercepted are frustratingly vague. Just cryptic references to devices called Eradicators.
If anyone can get to the truth of it, you can.
I'm plugging myself into the monitors while I sleep, hoping my subconscious will sort it out. No luck so far. Not much to be done at the moment. You need to focus on taking the Terra network apart. As you eliminate the larger cells, we can identify more terrorist activity centers. Eliminate enough, and the network will lose cohesion.
Then I'll proceed to the next cell.
I'll do everything I can from here. It's been 4 days since I stepped outside the Citadel. But I'm in no hurry. I'll be in touch. Watcher 2 out. This is Watcher 2. I'm receiving your signal. Transmission secure. Nice to have you on a world with modern holonet transceivers. You're coming in loud and clear, Cypher 9.
What's the situation?
I'll sum up what we know and let you judge for yourself. Nar Shaddaa is one of the most densely populated city worlds in the galaxy. It's also a major trade hub for criminals and corporations. That's why the terrorists are here. The local cell procures weapons and technology for the Eagle's entire network.
What kind of technology?
Everything from state-of-the-art computer equipment and starship parts to adrenals and combat armor. These terrorists aren't thugs. They're intelligent, coordinated, and well hidden. I've contacted an asset who claims he can help locate them. He's a former operative of ours, effective in his day. When he had to be retired, he was redesignated Watcher X.
There's something you're not saying.
Watcher X was one of our most capable analysts, but he became paranoid, prone to seeing connections and conspiracies where none existed. He was judged unstable and confined to Shadow Town, a Nar Shaddaa slum rebuilt as an open prison. It's where the Empire holds people who know too much. People we might need later. That's all I'm authorized to say.
Send me coordinates and I'll pay him a visit.
Done. Thank you. Shadow Town residents are fitted with motion tracking implants set to explode if they escape. This should keep Watcher X under control. Nonetheless, don't underestimate him. Watcher 2 out.
Step inside. Scan the apartment for important things. Overt threats, escape routes, access terminals. Take your time. Now, look again. Scan for concealed weapons, hiding places. Anything innocent is probably a bug. Anything you don't recognize should be analyzed later. Play the game. I can wait.
Are you Watcher X?
Yes. Formerly Watcher 5, formerly Minder 8. Not that you're authorized to know it.
Got a lot of brass for someone living in filth.
You're a cipher agent. Specializations in disguise, seduction, infiltration, assassination. You're brave to come to Shadow Town. This could be your future. A bomb in your head, trapped here like a criminal.
Stop stalling and start helping. Now.
Of course. Watcher 2, my sister in the eugenics program, told me what you need. You know that the Eagle's terrorists are using Nar Shaddaa as a supply hub, but I imagine you don't know their latest scheme. The terror cell is on the verge of acquiring mass quantities of a new genetic modification serum, Cyclone. They plan to distribute it across the Eagle's network.
What's this serum do?
Cyclone increases a user's speed and focus, transforming an average human into a natural assassin. It's also lethal. A minor defect. We need to learn who created the serum and find their link to the terrorists. You must obtain a sample. A Cyclone dose or a user's blood specimen.
Where would I get a dose of Cyclone?
Distribution is done anonymously, but Cyclone is available to the underworld. Gangsters are excellent test subjects. There's an augmentation shop in the Corellian sector, a place people go for fast, dangerous modifications. Purchase the Cyclone there. I can give you an injection to mimic the effects of long-term genetic damage. You'll be slower and weaker, but you'd make a convincing Cyclone buyer.
I'm not letting you inject me with anything.
As you like.
Probably the smart choice. Too bad. Wonder what he would have done to you.
Get to the shop, get me my Cyclone or my blood, then we find the link to your terrorist enemies. Get the Cyclone specimen. It's the only way to trace the serum to the terrorists.
Gahal Ravul Azjan Ujwet Untumata.
Zakazag Urgelu Kwalkunkas Urtumu Nula Uma.
Juguhu Zuza Haga Nuexa Nunsa Bahala.
Ulkulta Mete Judir Felpusuna Jormulu, O Kaleg.
Do exactly what I say, or you're dead.
Uma. Ormalo mentu gorastuk.
Uju nunsab tutub, guzu aga, nuesca numska bala. Rugel afna mul confu eses, quenu unsu sposu.
Luzatu munzu sunjal usublulu.
La zatu mun zu lujem pretenden untumaquen.
Uma, ormalo mentu gorastuk.
Hand over your medical serums, gene stims, everything you've got.
Jonulu hagan daralamutu ondota juestakon.
Warabulj dat statul dun unmod, tatolle ranza tuega.
Stay out of trouble, or I'll be back.
E kunet ungamasnetet accusata.
This is Watcher X. I've been waiting for your call. I assume you have my Cyclone specimen. Was there any trouble at the augmentation shop? Did you admire their work?
I have the serum. The shop's been dealt with.
Now, We need to analyze the specimen, figure out where Cyclone comes from. We'll need equipment I can't buy in Shadowtown. There's an abandoned medical laboratory in the Duros sector. If armed refugees haven't stripped it bare, you can run the analysis at the lab's bioscan.
What happens once I get the analysis?
You send the results to me. Then I think about Cyclone's connection to the terrorists. I'm very good at thinking. Hello again, Cypher. I'm seeing everything the bioscan sees. Genetic bonding agents, molecular webs. Pure. Perfect. Take Cyclone and it becomes you. I'm going deeper now, Cypher. Looking for a signature to tell us who the artist is. Curious?
I'll play along. What have you found?
I have a corporate match. Cyclone's coding process is registered to Sinchet Industries. Sinchet used to manufacture droids, food supplements, medical supplies. But Sinchet declared bankruptcy 5 years ago. The company is gone.
Someone else must be using their technology.
Sinchet, a dead company, is connected to Cyclone. Cyclone is connected to the Terror Cell. We need more. I'm finding one former Sinchet executive currently on Nar Shaddaa. He left the company just before it dissolved. Question him about Sinchet. We need to know what happened to their resources, whether they had terrorist connections.
Let me go talk to him.
Your executive is named Jordal Tlan. Rich, eccentric, reclusive. Stays in his private casino lounge. Only associates with droids. No visitors allowed, no weapons allowed. He'll need a reason to talk to you, to be desperate to talk to you.
Is there a way to blackmail him?
I think so. Use the resources you have. See those medical crates? Combine their chemicals correctly and you'll have an undetectable poison. Clan's serving droids won't notice if you poison his drink. When he sweats and chokes, offer the antidote in return for cooperation.
That's not a bad idea.
I'm sending the formulas for poison and antidote. The important thing is to get to Clan. Get him talking about the terrorists, Cyclone, and the dissolution of Sinchet.
Master Tlan requested my repairs be completed in time for tomorrow's swoop race broadcast. You are supposed to comply.
I'm not a mechanic. I can't keep repairing you things when you malfunction.
Then I shall inform Master Tlan of your inability to perform your duties.
That's not necessary. Why don't you clear your memory of the last 5 minutes? Hey, you! This is Master Tlan's lounge. Is there something I can help you with?
I hope I'm not intruding. What's your name?
I'm Natula Pan. I assist Master Jordal Tlan, tend his lounge and the droids. It's a pretty nice gig. When Tlan left the business world, he picked me up, bailed me out of debt. Now I work for one of the richest men on Nar Shaddaa.
Can you arrange a meeting for me?
You don't know who you're dealing with. Tlan doesn't take visitors. I'm the only person he's seen in a year. Even if I wanted to set you up with a meeting, and I don't, sorry, what would I tell him? Some stranger wants to chat?
Tell him an old friend wants to talk about Cyclone.
If you say so. I'll give him the message and see what he wants to do. Well, says I'll talk to you. Wouldn't plan on an extended visit, though. Go through that door, keep your distance from Tlan and the droids, and don't take too long. Got it?
I really appreciate your help.
Just be careful in there.
Alert! Scanning for weapons. Warning, visitor is armed.
Ignore the droids. Nutella says you're persistent, but I don't know what you think you'll find here.
Sinjit's gone. Bankrupted by the war and sold off piece by piece for a tidy sum. Made me rich, but that life is over.
I've been wanting to meet you. Your old company has been linked to terrorists.
I'd be more worried if I knew what you were talking about. Besides, you're nobody to me. Why would I reveal confidential information to you?
Cause trouble with me, and I can make your life very difficult.
Is that right? And how exactly would you do that?
You value your isolation. I can make you public.
No one can get in here unless I allow it. You're not going to let those breathing, sweating creatures into my lounge. I'll talk if it'll get rid of you. Here's a story you might be interested in. A story about Verve Gen, one of Sinchit's subsidiaries.
I'm listening. What did Verve Gen do?
Verve Gen developed medical technology, mainly genetic modification serums. Not one of Sinchit's more profitable branches. When we put Verve Gen on the market, we got some strange buyers. Paid cash and kept their names secret, took the company and all its technology.
Can you contact the buyers?
I wouldn't know how. You could try yourself. Verve Gen's offices were on the upper levels of the city. So far as I'm aware, the old buyers are still in charge. That's all I have, and I think I've been more than cooperative. Everything clear enough?
I appreciate all your help, Master T'lan.
You can see yourself out. Don't bother the droids when you go, and leave Natula alone.
Hello, Cypher. Always pleasant to speak. You know, I managed to slice into the Star Cluster's holocams. I got to see how you handle fieldwork. I didn't think it possible to talk through a meeting with Jordal T'lan. You handled yourself adeptly.
See? And you thought I'd need to poison him.
It seems I was mistaken. So, now we know about Verve Gen, a Sinchet Industries medical subsidiary purchased by a shadowy group of buyers. Those buyers were presumably members of the Terra Cell. The company was acquired to produce Cyclone and other technologies.
I reached the same conclusion.
I've located the Verve Gen offices, but I'm unable to obtain personnel records. Their data is very well secured. I need you to set up surveillance. Slice into public terminals around the building perimeter, and I can use Holonet resources to see and hear inside.
Say we're successful. Then what?
We analyze the situation. Determine our best approach. Verve Gen is located in the upper-level industrial sites. The sector is overrun by corporate security. Some may carry Cyclone as a last resort. When you're done, come to Shadow Town. We'll meet in person. Watch your X out.
Welcome back, Cypher. Glad you could visit. Most people in Shadowtown seek escape. Spies. Assassins. Freedom is the only reason they'd help the Empire. But Imperial Intelligence isn't offering me freedom. You know why?
I was wondering about that.
Imperial Intelligence is scared to let me free. But the Watchers know that if I refuse to help, my mental conditioning reacts. If I disobey a superior, I get headaches. They last for days. So I may as well help you. The alternative is less pleasant.
Has intelligence done that to anyone else?
Oh, yes. But I know you're eager to get back to business. Now that we have surveillance, I've been able to monitor Verve Gen's activities. The results are enlightening. As we suspected, they're manufacturing Cyclone. In fact, Verve Gen is preparing a large quantity of serum for transport and distribution.
They're transferring the Cyclone to other cells in the network.
That's exactly right. Verve Gen's day-to-day management is expecting a visit from the owners. That's when the Cyclone will be turned over. Security will increase. Employees sent home, holocams activated, internal defenses powered on. But get into the meeting unnoticed, and you'll find the Terra Cell leaders.
Then we can eliminate the terrorists and destroy the Cyclone.
An appropriate solution. But the approach will require delicacy. With effort, we can create a cybernetic disguise combining armor, implants, and holographic technology. You would appear to be a Class 5 droid. Most security devices don't screen mindless droid workers. Fitted with such a camouflage system, You could walk into Vervgen unmolested.
How do we get this working?
I've already assembled the system's components. All that remains is to implant the cybernetics necessary to hide your life readings. I can put you to sleep with an anesthetic before making the incisions. Otherwise, we can begin. The procedure should be swift.
There's no way I'm letting you knock me out.
As you like. I'll go as fast as possible. There. I've inserted 3 implants along your spinal column. The pain should fade quickly. Congratulations. From now on, you'll be able to pass as a machine.
We're losing time. What's next?
It won't be long before the cell leaders arrive at Vervgen. I suggest you get to the meeting. Eliminate everyone. Afterward, I'll contact you for confirmation. Good luck, Cypher.
After the test results came in, we made some modifications. The serum lasts longer, and the side effects kick in later. But it's still lethal. No matter what we do, Cyclone will burn up its users from the inside out.
I'm not concerned about fatalities. The men and women taking the serum understand the necessity of sacrifice. This is an important day for us. You've created a new weapon in our fight for freedom. One that we'll use to great advantage.
We're all honored to hear that from the Eagle, sir. Vervgen is your partner in the cause.
How do you want to proceed?
You and your men will distribute Cyclone to the cells and continue overseeing Nar Shaddaa. Vervgen will remain under your watch. Wraith and Pradot will continue managing the business.
I appreciate your faith in me, sir.
Smugglers are ready and waiting. As soon as we're done here, I'll get the serum to them.
Excellent. If we need Vervgen again, I'll contact you. Otherwise, use your initiative. End transmission.
You heard him. Grab the serum and go. Wraithen...
I'm sorry, sir. I was doing a full sensor scan, and that droid over there is showing unusual readings.
I don't recognize it. Certainly shouldn't be in the conference room.
I'm here to kill you.
Let's deal with this intruder.
Something's wrong with the internal defenses. I can't get a response.
Secure the building, and don't let anyone escape. Anyone who needs a boost from Cyclone, take it.
Recording function activated. Self-diagnosis. Critical. I'm going to die. I'm looking at the woman who's going to kill me.
A cyborg. How convenient. You eliminated the cell leaders. Now we must remove every trace of their operation and prevent their followers from regrouping. The terrorist communications hub, the system they use to arrange meetings, store secrets, broadcast propaganda, must be destroyed. The man at your feet is our opportunity.
I thought stopping the meeting would end this.
There are always survivors. Terrorists scattered around Nar Shaddaa. You can deny them the resources to rebuild.
I don't know anything.
We can use his computer-enhanced brain to locate the hub. You'll need to route me to his cortical implant.
What? You can't do that!
There should be a standard interface somewhere on his skull. Connect your holocommunicator, and I can slice the data inside his mind.
Please, I'll tell you what you need to know. Just don't slice my brain.
It's nothing personal, but it is necessary.
Please don't!
I'm inside. He's Aethel Yarn, born on Dantooine. 16 years old, he comes to Nar Shaddaa, works for the Exchange, earns his cybernetics. 19 years, he's recruited by the Nar Shaddaa Terror Cell, starts as nothing, but his enhancements prove useful to men higher up. They connect him to the cell's communications hub. Feed him codes and patterns. Now the coordinates are mine.
Where am I going next?
The hub is in the network access sector. A maze of computers and holonet transceivers. You'll have to pass the cell's security droids to reach it. Certainly within your capabilities. Once you're there, disable the terminal. Then the Nar Shaddaa terror cell will cease to exist.
Can't.
Consider this an act of mercy.
Congratulations, Cypher. You've struck the final blow to the Terra Cell. Survivors will be unable to regroup. Ties to the Eagle's network have been severed. There's only one catch. Destroying the network hub sent a ripple through the holonet. Shadowtown security momentarily failed. I took the opportunity to escape.
Escaping was your real goal all along.
I knew working with intelligence would expand my options. It wasn't until we met that I formulated a plan.
Damn son of a sow.
Soon one of your watchers will notice the glitch. You'll be asked to find me. Hunt me. But I don't want you as an enemy. Tell your watcher that I remain imprisoned. Once I'm safe, I'll share my secrets. You'll know everything intelligence keeps from its ciphers.
How do I know you'd keep your end of the deal?
You don't. But consider the possibilities. Do you want the details of the eugenics program that bred myself and Watcher 2? The aliases of your friend, Kaleo Janis?
You sleazy freak. Think you can play? You're dead. You're so dead.
It's yours. All the secrets. You only have to help me escape Nar Shaddaa.
If you think you can turn me, you're wasting your time.
I'm sorry you feel that way. Now, I should be going. I have to get to my ship. You have an incoming call from your masters. Goodbye, Cypher.
Cypher 9, this is Watcher 2. I'm routing this call through a half dozen city subsystems. We intercepted a set of terrorist transmissions reporting the destruction of a company called Verve Gen. I've sent agents to scour the company's systems for additional data. It seems the Nar Shaddaa cell has been neutralized.
I just destroyed the cell's communications hub. It could have salvageable data.
I'll alert the teams. There's also something else. As I was monitoring, I noticed some unusual network activity. It's possible Shadowtown's security was breached. I'm worried about Watcher X. He'd take advantage of a fault like that.
I'm going after him now. He called me to gloat.
Damn it all. We can't have a rogue Watcher loose in the galaxy. Head for the spaceport. I'll try to delay any departures, but be fast. Nar Shaddaa doesn't acknowledge Imperial authority.
Don't worry. He's not getting out of the city.
It's good to hear you say that. Watcher 2 out.
That's the spirit. Let's kill that filth.
Look around. Note your target. Check him for weapons. Held. Concealed. Improvised. Now scan the rest of the area. Does he have allies? Are they hiding? Are you outmatched without realizing? I'm disappointed in you, Cypher. I offered you information that could have given you power over your masters.
I knew what I was doing when I took this job.
So many operatives say that. I owe you my release, but I have no qualms about us fighting. If you'd like to back out, you may.
It's too late for both of us.
As you like. Goodbye, Agent. Now we reach the end.
You won't make it out of this. No one ever does.
Guess that's done. I'd kick around his body, but the bomb in his head might go off. Too bad he decided to play you. If he had dealt straight, Betty could have told his keeper's real name.
He missed his chance. I have no pity for him.
Yeah. For a guy who thought so much of himself, he really wasn't that smart.
Cypher 9, this is Watcher 2. Please respond. I need a status update on Watcher X. I'm ready to put out a general alert.
The situation is resolved. Watcher X is dead.
That's excellent news. Well done. I'll downgrade our security status. Operations will proceed as normal. For the record, Cypher, I don't enjoy violence, but I'm extremely happy that Watcher X is out of commission.
I was hoping to bring him back to Shadow Town.
Then frankly, I'm glad the situation forced your hand. I'll send a crew to collect Watcher X's corpse. His mind and body are Imperial technology. Consider the matter closed. Records of his presence here will be erased, and you're not to speak of this further. I'll debrief you back at the ship.
This is Cypher 9 to Watcher 2. Please respond.
Contact authorization denied. This is Imperial Automated Defense Corps Unit CR-97. By order of Darth Jared, Lord of the Dark Council, your ship is now in lockdown.
Cypher 9, the last time we spoke, I called you to Korriban. Did you misunderstand what a privilege that audience was?
It was a great honor. I only hope to live up to your expectations.
You've failed so far. I haven't heard a word from you about Darth Jadis' assassination. But you deserve another chance. Now, my peers on the Dark Council acknowledge me, but they don't yet respect me, not like they did my father. To secure my position, I must have my father's secrets, the mysteries Darth Jadis never deigned to teach me.
My task will be to find these secrets.
Your task is to find one whom Jadis trusted. I was his only apprentice, but he favored force-blind advisors over his own daughter. Of course, most of his advisors died with him on the Dominator, but not all. Vior Yanol stayed behind. Vior Yanol fled to Nar Shaddaa.
Was he afraid of something? And why Nar Shaddaa?
I expect that when Jadis died, Yanol knew no one could keep him safe anymore. And again, maybe Yanol conspired with Jadis' rivals. Maybe he was involved in my father's death. The end result is the same. My sources have found his hideout. You will catch him and bring him to me. Until then, we are finished.
Get away! I've done nothing to you! I've touched nothing on this dust ball! No talk to no one!
I'm not here to hurt you.
The Dark Council hired you, didn't it? Or the Galactic Republic, the Macrozza Order, the Hutts! It doesn't matter. My master is dead. Darth Jadis is gone. I have no one left to betray.
I'm not asking you to betray anyone. Darth Jared sent me.
Jared? Ah! The idiot girl thinks she can equal her father, eh?
You really don't understand. Lord Jadis must have made preparations for his death. He was power, and fire, and brilliance. The instant the Master died, I promise his contingency plans went into action. They'll bring doom to everything Lord Jadis ever touched, and I want no part of it.
It's already too late for that.
Fool! Everyone Jadis ever touched will all be destroyed! Oh!
Still alive, but he's not getting up soon. Now we have to drag him to the ship.
Let's load him up and get going.
You know, you'd think a high-up advisor would carry a few more credits.
This is Keeper to Cipher 9. I understand you're running an errand for Darth Jorid. It may not be my place to know a Dark Council member's business, so I won't ask what she wants. I only want to advise you to take care.
That's unusually thoughtful of you, Keeper.
These are unusual circumstances. Would that they were different. Jorid has relocated to Darth Jadis' old chambers on Drummond Cass. She awaits you there. Keeper, out.
Come in, dear Cipher. I was just listening to Lord Ulios' latest opera. Music brightens my day, and we of the Council have few bright days. You can't imagine the burden.
I'm sure I can't.
So, Vior Yanol, is that him? Or is this another body for my collection?
I retrieved Yanol, as you commanded.
Oh, Agent. Yanol and I are going to spend some time together. He's going to reveal every secret my father ever had. Expect a token of my appreciation. And expect to be called on again, my Cipher.
It'll give me something to look forward to.
Think of it. Dream of me, and of your service to me. You're trying my patience.
Transmitting security codes, this is Watcher 2 to Cipher 9. I'm glad you're back on duty. After you dismantle the cells on Balmora and Nar Shaddaa, the rest of the Terran network went into overdrive.
How are they responding exactly?
Increased chatter, transfer of goods, activation of safe houses. Fascinating, really. I told you before about the Eagle's mystery weapon, the Eradicator devices. We still don't know what they are, but we intercepted this transmission.
Once the devices are fully functional, I'll enter the targeting codes myself. Only then will instructions be sent. But all cells are encouraged to prepare attacks on secondary targets. Once the Eradicators cause chaos in every Imperial stronghold, you must fan the flames. Stand tall above the wreckage. Shape the destruction into a message. That is how we prevail.
That was the Eagle himself. It seems the assassination of Darth Jadis was only the start.
We've eliminated two of his terror cells. We can stop this.
I've run the odds. I wish I were as certain as you. There is good news. We have leads on two new terror cells, vital to the network's operation. They're your next targets. Proceed to Tatooine and Alderaan at your discretion. Your mission will continue there. Watcher 2 out.
I think the Huttis smell is off my boots. Should have kicked in more faces while it lasted.
All that time in the swamp. Tell me you don't want to go home. Keep Nemra company.
If I get the urge to see the Hutt, it'll take me back. In the meantime, though, you and me against the galaxy. It's gonna be fun. All blasters and girl talk.
You shoot high, I'll shoot low.
That's the spirit. Let's get moving. So we're clear. Imperial rations are nasty, and I lived on grubs and 2-credit wine for a year. They raise you on those things. No wonder you're a bunch of stiffs.
You make it sound like you don't like the Imperial lifestyle.
Only time I kneel is to puke in the refresher. Here's what I don't get. You got a little brass, you got a little style. You're not totally one of them. But you still play Keeper's pet, shoot all the right people when you could work for... whoever.
You've seen the people trying to destroy us. The Republic, terrorists, traitors. Someone needs to stop them.
You're serious? That's sweet. Me? I'm in long enough to lay low, pick up some cash, sort out some personal stuff you guys can help with. Then I'm gone.
Who knows? I show you a good time. You might change your mind.
You're fun, Agent, but you're not that fun.
Watcher 2 to Cipher 9. Link established with Mos Ila spaceport. Updating encryption protocols. And transmission secure. I assume the flight was uneventful.
Not much of anything here, is there?
That's how it looks on the surface. Tatooine's a desert world. Binary star system, minimal life forms, sparsely populated by farmers and petty criminals. Mos Ila is the sole Imperial outpost. Not normally somewhere we'd expect terrorists to congregate. But these are unusual terrorists. The Ghost Cell.
Unusual in what way? Methodology? Politics? Species?
Methodology and function. Years ago, we heard rumors of a training program for hardened radicals. A terror cell specializing in stealth, infiltration, and assassination. Information now suggests this Ghost Cell is real. Elite support for the Eagle's network.
Some lead to bring the cell from rumor to priority one.
The attack on Drummond Cass forced us to re-examine our assumptions, accept new possibilities. We're targeting Tatooine on the word of an anonymous source claiming to be a former Ghost Cell member. The source says that stopping the terrorists is a matter of conscience. He wants a face-to-face meeting.
I'll make contact. He shouldn't be hard to turn.
Profiling agrees. 74% odds. Soothe his paranoia and dispose of him when you've eliminated the cell. He's waiting for a call from a holocom terminal in town. Stay on guard. Watcher 2 out.
I don't appreciate being jerked around. Who is this anyway? Who sent you?
I'm with intelligence. You don't need to know my name.
Fine, no names. I'll talk about the terrorists, but I need a guarantee. If we're going to meet, no one can know. Not the Ghost Cell, not Imperial Security.
Give me your location and stay put.
I can't. We each come halfway, or we don't do this at all. There are sentry droids all around town. Imperial model, but everyone knows their holocam feeds are insecure. The Ghost Cell could use them to find me. Take out the droids and I can make our rendezvous.
Say I agree. Where do we make contact?
Once you've dealt with the sentries, head to the market. Give the droids holocams to a merchant named Dr. Wiss. He'll send you to me.
You'll get your safe passage. Then we talk.
Smells like a sweaty farmer. Great spot for a dead drop.
Good droids. Many droids. You're coming to shop now? Yes. You look around.
I'm not in the market for droids, but I've got holocams to sell.
Holocams? Yes. Yes, for these we make an exchange. I get holocams, you get shiny mouse droid. Good condition.
Thank you. I'm sure that'll do nicely.
Yes, yes. Look, your droid is getting away. Better follow him.
On Hutta, we used mouse droids for target practice.
Huh? Keep your weapons down. I don't want to fight, I just... You sure you weren't followed?
I followed your instructions, and I was watching all the way. We're safe.
Safe. All right. My name is Mia Hawkins. I'm not giving you the runaround, it's just... The Ghost Cell can look like anyone. Holographic disguise.
Holographic disguises will only get you so far.
They're not... Let me start over. I used to be part of Cobalt Flag, the anti-occupation group on Sullust. We fought the Empire, organized bombings and sabotage. Didn't work. Last year, Imp Security cracked down. Most of us died. I was approached by people who offered me a way out. Retraining.
So your buddies died while you joined the Elite? Good deal.
Stop it! It wasn't like that! The Eagle's people smuggled me into Tatooine, brought me to this weird empty village in the middle of the desert. The Ghost Cell lived there, a few dozen fighters from around the galaxy, training under their leader, the Old Man.
No real name, I take it.
He was ancient, brilliant. He taught us how to move unseen, kill anyone. The Old Man's village was an empty model. We could experiment with bombs, sniper fire, whatever. I spent months there. Then they started kidnapping civilians, brought them to the village so we could practice. That's when I slipped away.
A whole town mocked up so you could learn terrorism.
Those people were innocent. There are limits, they're... The Ghost Cell has to stop. I don't know where the village is. They kept us sedated coming and going, but I had a thought. The cell gets food and supplies from some smuggler in town. Name of Dragon Eyes. If we can flesh him out, he can lead us there.
We make noise, Dragon Eyes takes the bait.
Exactly. I patched together these tracking devices. Wouldn't be hard to plant them on customers in the local cantina. People who know things. Then you ask around for Dragon Eyes, loud and public. Someone's bound to try and warn him, and with the trackers, we can see who.
Believe me, I can make a scene.
I'll monitor the trackers and call you when someone gets in touch with Dragon Eyes. But work fast, okay?
So the Imperials come in with three astromech droids, and I'm thinking to myself... I see. You want something? I'm a little busy here.
You're going to tell me how to find Dragon Eyes. And you're going to tell me now.
Whoa, I don't know what you're talking about. Look, a lot of people pass through here. I can't keep track of them all. What's this guy to you?
Dragon Eyes cheated me. Betrayed me and almost got me killed. I want to repay the favor.
I won't stop you, just don't shoot up the place, huh? Please?
Let's ask around, see if one of these losers can find a clue.
Good news. An old Rodian left the cantina a few minutes ago. Fidgety. Nervous. I'm tracking him. Might be going to Dragon Eyes. The bad news is, Ghost Cell assassins are all over. They're coming to kill you.
Let them try. I won't make it easy.
Yeah, I bet you won't. But say you survive. Half of them are using stealth tech, half of them are disguised as locals. You won't find them all. They'll keep following, waiting. And sooner or later, you'll have a knife in your throat. It's how they work. You need to get them off your back and now. Take the offensive. Draw them into an ambush.
Any specific suggestions?
Grab a speeder out of town. There's an old wind farm not far. Plenty of cover. And dust's good for jamming stealth. Should hide the bodies, too. Look, I have to go. They'll be looking for me. Talk later.
Come out. The wind speaks your name. The sand would bury your corpse. You have asked improper questions. The old man has determined your fate.
Really? Then I have a surprise for you.
We shall see.
Ha ha ha!
They're all dead? What did you do in here? Forget that, you're amazing. Do they hurt you?
I thought you were hiding back in town.
What? No, I wanted to make sure you were okay. Let me take a look at you. They use poison sometimes. Even a scratch can be nasty.
You should have told me about the poison earlier.
What's wrong with you? I'm trying to help and you're just making accusations.
Never lie to a professional liar.
You will fall along with the traitor.
Hello? Still alive out there?
One of the assassins looked like you. Care to explain?
What? Blast! The ghost cell is very good at imitation. Holograms. The old man is better. Not surprised he trained someone to be me.
A disguise like that isn't easy to pull off. I should know.
Well, maybe you and the old man can exchange tips sometime. Now, while you were fighting, I think the Tracer's got a lock on Dragon Eyes. Let's meet up before this call gets intercepted. There's a trading post near our man's location. I can make it there.
Just don't get killed on the way. Where do we meet?
I'll wait for you in one of the storage areas. Should be safe, if you're quick. And if... I have to go.
You made it, huh? I had a detonator primed just in case. I can probably turn it off now.
I could do without being blown to bits by an ally.
Suppose so. I told you I tracked down Dragon Eyes. Your trap led straight to the terrorist supplier. Real nasty sort named Milos Varda. He works for the local crime syndicate. Group called The Exchange.
Been a while since I dealt with the underworld. I'm out of practice.
I don't know a lot about them. The Exchange runs spice, gambling, extortion, broken legs and blown up speeders. Not a shock their guy's connected to the ghost cell. Milos must get supplies through Masila and ship them to the village.
We need to know how he does it. I'll pay him a visit.
I'm sure he has exchange protection, but his house isn't far. Afterwards, we can meet back here.
Oh, I didn't hear anyone come in. The guards usually call. If you had an appointment, you should know. My husband is out on business. He'll be back soon.
If Milos were here, I could have left you alone. As it is...
What are you doing? Where are my guards? Please, please don't do this to us. Whatever you want.
I want to know what sort of work Milos does.
He never says much. He's never said much, even when he was a moisture farmer. I know he's not involved with the nicest people, but he's not a bad man, I swear.
If you don't know anything, I'll have to go to the source. Take a seat.
All right. Please, don't hurt him.
Isbeth, I'm back! You, what have you done? How dare you invade my home?
You and I are going to have a talk.
What does she mean? What's this all about?
Shut up! Just stay calm. You were the one asking questions. I was promised you wouldn't survive.
I did survive. And you're going to help me find the ghost cell.
You have no idea who they are. The ghost cell came to me. They offered the exchange protection. Assassins. If we gave them what they needed... What could I say? They're worse than we are. And now you think you frighten me?
I do horrible things too, Milos. Tell me where the cell is based.
I could tell you, please! I beg whatever they need. Leave the shipment at a drop point in the canyons. They take the crates home by speeder. The next delivery is soon. That's all I know.
That'll do. Cause me any trouble and I'll be back.
I understand. I will not cause difficulties.
Come, Ismet. Let's get away from here.
Hello. I'm recording this message for you. Funny thing is, I don't know your name. By now you've talked to Milos. I hope he gave you what you need to find the village, because I've done all I can. Even sent everything I know about the Eagle's network to intelligence. But now I'm leaving, because I know how this ends. After the ghost cell is neutralized, you turn me in. Well, I had a few doubts. You don't seem awful, but you're still an Imperial, and I know where your loyalties lie. Anyway, destroy the village. Kill the old man. They're not part of the Resistance. There's something evil.
I used to blow things up too, but I don't get self-righteous about it. Anyway, what now? We're down by one.
Imperial intelligence will find her. In the meantime, we have work.
Got it. Check out the drop point next. Get ourselves a ride to the terror cell. Well, there's stuff here. Guess the ghost cell hasn't picked up its delivery.
Get the crates open and climb inside. We're taking a ride.
Worst part is, I've traveled this way before.
Welcome, my child. I wondered whether you'd find your way.
I'm so sorry. I couldn't stop them.
I applauded you toward the end. You've trampled my garden, of course. But I admire your skills.
The old man. You trained the ghost cell.
Indeed. So many students in this day and age. It's rewarding work.
Be careful. He'll kill you.
Don't mind your friend. We found her in the spaceport and thought we'd bring her home.
We could have killed her, of course. But what reward would that be when she's served so well?
You don't have to show off for my sake.
A trick of the light. Besides, after a while, changing becomes second nature. Surely you've noticed.
The truth is, I let Mia defect. From the moment she began training, I saw that she was weak. Unworthy.
I knew she would flee and turn on us. She was the perfect bait to lure an Imperial intelligence cipher.
Whatever you were planning, all you've arranged is your defeat.
I beg to differ. We've been watching you, learning your techniques. In Mosila, at the wind farm, in exchange territory, syncing our emotions with yours.
You're fantastically talented. You'll show us everything, and then we'll replace you inside your own organization. I'm looking forward to killing you. All that's left is your defeat and subjugation. The Eagle will triumph. You don't know what you're doing.
You don't know how many lies are at work. No idea what's really going on.
You'll have plenty of time to explain in your cell.
Thank you. No. I will not be taken. Poison.
It's really him. He's really dead. I'm sorry about everything. I didn't know what he was planning. I can't believe he used me.
If you hadn't run off and been captured, this might have gone smoother.
I left a message for you. Like I said, I couldn't stay. I'm not an Imperial. I guess that doesn't matter now. We're both here. I'm in no shape to fight. What do we do about it?
You're the last terrorist here. You die, and my job is done.
That's what I thought.
Even I'm feeling a little sick from all the blood. We done?
Mission complete. Let's get off planet.
Wanna go somewhere with less sand? Maybe more people?
Secure transmission established. This is Watcher 2. Your efforts to destabilize the Terra network are working better than expected, Cypher. Unfortunately, I don't have good news. We attempted to capture the Eagle in a raid on Tholaton. We found a base, but the man had moved on.
Is there a trail we can follow?
No. I'm still hopeful your efforts will draw him into the open. We've also been researching the so-called Eradicator devices. They're satellites, orbital strike weapons with enough firepower to level a city. Here's the bizarre thing. The terrorists aren't building the Eradicators, they're growing them.
What do you mean, growing?
The Eradicators are a combination of biological and mechanical components, organic batteries in a weaponized shell. The terrorists don't need factories anymore, they can grow Eradicators wherever there's room.
Cheap, destructive, and disposable.
Our people are jealous they didn't think it up. We'll continue gathering information. We know what the Eradicators are, but not where or how they'll be used. You have your own mission. Destroy the cells, and they'll lead us to the Eagle. Watcher 2 out. Stand by. I'm routing comm traffic through our mid-rim outposts. You're on a 6-second delay until I resynchronize the data stream. 3, 2, 1. Synced and secured. Tracking systems show you're in the castle lands of Alderaan. Enjoy the view, Cypher. I hear the mountains are lovely.
After the last few worlds, I'll be sure to appreciate it.
It'll keep you sane. Alderaan is governed by the wealthiest noble families in the galaxy. They've feuded for centuries, and are presently engaged in a full-scale war. You're here because Imperial Intelligence believes that one of the noble houses, or a noble within one of the houses, is financing the Eagle's Terra network.
What sort of financing are we talking about?
Money for weapons, transportation, bribes, anything the cells need. The Empire's resources are tied up supporting House Thul's efforts to claim the throne. But intelligence does have one asset, Vector Hillas. Vector was an Imperial ambassador to the nobles, but he was later repurposed. Now he's with the Killix, Alderaan's native alien species.
Why are you being cagey, Watcher 2?
Apologies. Vector's is an unusual case, and I should explain. When Vector approached the Killix on a mission of diplomacy, they absorbed him into their collective intelligence. He's part of their hive mind. However, he continues to file activity reports, and we believe he's still loyal to the Empire, even if he's barely human anymore.
A lack of humanity shouldn't compromise anyone.
There are always exceptions, but we mustn't forget that they're rare. We've requisitioned Vector from the diplomatic service and given him a need-to-know overview. You'll rendezvous at these coordinates. Use him to eliminate any noble or house funding the terrorists. Watcher 2 out.
Yes, this is the one, as the song schedule determined.
I can't wait to see how this goes.
We are Vector Hillas, Dawn Herald of the Ouroboro Nest. Pleased to make your acquaintance, Agent.
Cypher 9. I'm with Imperial Intelligence.
Of course. We trust our appearance doesn't disturb you. Our superiors in the diplomatic service find our joining disconcerting, but it was necessary. The joining allowed us to share thoughts and senses with the Nest, forge a bond between Empire and Kilix. The change is a small price.
Changed or not, you clean up well.
You're very kind. We'd rub forearms, but it might not translate. Yes, as to your target. Imperial intelligence provided us with a list of names, dates, and locations connected to your terrorist financier.
Do you have an ID on the target?
We can't identify the financier himself, but your information shows he's visited House Organa, House Ceres, House Pantier, and House Cortes. Cortes is a vassal of the Empire's proxy, House Thule. If you show the Cortes Baron a copy of our findings, he might close in on your foe.
If I can manipulate a hut, I can handle a baron.
A hut? Indeed. We must proceed to the Dance of Unlighting, but we'll remain here for the duration of your mission. We suggest you present yourself to Cortes as an ally of the Empire. Show strength, and don't mention your intelligence connections.
Hold your guard. In the name of Baron Payar Cortes and the Cortes Barony, I demand you state your business or face expulsion.
I am one of the free soldiers of the Palemian trade route, come to offer my company's services.
Another mercenary thug, then. Come to Alderaan for a few credits.
Best mercenary thug this side of the rim.
Captain Perovius, there's no need to react this way.
Forgive me, my lady.
I am Baroness Che Cortes. Forgive our lack of hospitality, but these are inhospitable times. And quite frankly, Cortes has no need of mercenaries. Friends, yes, but not armies for hire.
Allow me to prove that I can be a friend.
Perhaps. Some days ago, we lost a squad of battle droids patrolling the borders of Cortes lands. That squad was our first line of defense. We believe the squad's disappearance may presage an attack, yet not one of our allies has come to our aid.
What happened to the squad, exactly?
We don't know what destroyed our droids. They went silent. Until we find out, we must prepare for the worst. If you want our favor, send your troops to determine the fate of our patrol. Perhaps then my baron may host guests.
We'll do everything possible to make this right.
I'll leave you to Captain Perovius. I hope to see you under better circumstances.
If your troops find the droids, tell them to activate the squad's homing beacon. Perhaps the data logs will help us.
This is Captain Perovius. It's good to see you again. I'm impressed that you conducted the search personally. We're receiving the droid's logs now. You have my thanks.
No thanks are necessary. It was my privilege.
I would have lost men conducting the search. You saved lives today. At any rate, these logs are discouraging. The droid skirmish with the Kilix. Blasted bugs are on Cortes lands again.
I ran into a few more on my way here.
Figures as much. Rumor has it that the Kilix nest is growing. Probably scouting for a new home. I'll make sure the Baron knows. Those things won't build a new hive in Cortes territory, I'll tell you that.
I'm sure the Kilix will get your message.
Indeed. In the meantime, I have a message for you. The Baroness is offering you an invitation to the estate. You may return at your leisure.
The Baron is expecting you. This way, please.
Our guest has arrived, my lord.
Baron Payar Cortes, Sword of the Castle Lands, I hereby present to you an honorable friend and a soldier of fortune. This woman risked herself in the service of House Cortes, valiantly recovering our lost patrol and identifying the Kilix threat. In appreciation of her noble deeds, and out of respect for her accomplishments, I ask that you grant her recognition.
I so grant her recognition. I am Baron Payar Cortes, my lady. Welcome to my home.
Allow me to present Kaleo Janus, my loyal and trusted associate.
Such an exotic young woman. How is it you come to be here?
I slid out of Mama's womb and picked up a blaster. Now I'm your new friend's bodyguard. Of course, you and me could be friends, too. You got a nice place here. I could stick around a while.
Baron?
You are an intriguing creature, I admit.
Hear what he said? That was sweet.
I think you've caught his interest.
What can I say? Baron needs some excitement in his life.
I assure you, my husband has enough excitement.
Tell me now, why do you seek my house? Is there a favor you would ask? An alliance you'd propose?
I'm trying to identify a visitor to House Cortez. I know when he was here, but not his name or face.
I'll gladly help. Show me what you have. The dates in your files, yes, we've had visitors at these times, but that's no surprise. I believe the guest you're looking for is Master Denry Ale. We've hosted him and his summits on a number of occasions.
Tell me where to find this man.
Ah, well, it may not be so easy as that. Denry Ale was once Lord Denry Ale, a powerful and respected man among the vassal houses. But some years ago, he abdicated his position.
He became a mediator dedicated to forging peace.
Strange you should ask about him now. For several weeks, Denry Ale has been missing. Whether off on some secret negotiation or something more regrettable, no one knows.
We can't let him disappear. It would be unfortunate.
I'll begin looking into Ale's whereabouts through formal and informal diplomatic channels. If I can find him for you, I will. You may also wish to investigate the matter yourself. I'm sure a mercenary of your caliber has sources.
You'll let me know if you find anything.
Of course. I'll send a message immediately. In the meantime, you're welcome to stay as a guest. House Cortez prides itself on its hospitality.
We'll have to dine together. You can meet the Ack Dogs.
The Baron has spoken. This audience is at an end.
Is it me, or are there more bugs than last time?
Welcome back. Your aura reflects your attunement to the Great Song.
Vector, good to see you again, too.
Our observers saw you enter the Cortez estate. The Fingerlings were listening and heard mention of Denry Ale. We met Ale during our time as ambassador. With his wealth and talent, he could be your target.
The Baron claims not to know his whereabouts.
We might be able to help. Our nest has had many joiners over the years. Soldiers, children, nobles. We can search their memories and see what they know of Denry Ale.
Are all these people in the nest like you?
As Dawn Herald and emissary to the Empire, we retain more independence. But we're all joiners. We remember Pabal Alder. When her speeder crashed, our foragers brought her to the Hive. Our healers tended her. We became one. Her house, House Alder, an old house of scholars and antiquarians, granted Ale residence in honor of his work as a mediator. Ale kept records of his work in the Alder estate. If you can penetrate the estate's defenses, those records are yours.
Good work. I'll have those records in no time.
If we may be so bold. A warning. House Alder opposes the Empire, and the estate is always prepared for an Imperial attack, even a stealthy one. Be careful. We recommend that you visit House Alder. It's the best way of locating our terrorist financier. Agent, it's good to see you. Yes, We apologize. The nest has been invigorated by star dancing. If you could smell the pheromones, you'd understand our restlessness.
This restlessness, is it going to be a problem?
There's nothing to be concerned about. The hive is growing, and we all benefit. We even have a gift for you. These orbs contain white membrosia, rare nectar produced by our givers. Pull back the wax and sip. You'll find it gives strength and healing.
Practical, but exotic. I like it.
We hoped you might. In any case, how's the search for Denry Ale?
I found records in the Alder estate, but I am not sure what to make of them.
This is perplexing. It looks like Ale funded the destruction of the Dominator and the assassination of Darth Jadus. But the rest is very odd. Have you shown this to Baron Pear?
I was just on my way.
Of course. We appreciate being kept apprised. We know you're under no obligation. We'll be on alert, should you need anything else. The nest embraces our unity.
Welcome back. I'll let the Baron know you're here.
My dear, you shouldn't concern yourself with trifling details.
I am concerned. This house needs all I can give, not just my gardening skills.
Enough, we'll speak later. Ah, the mercenary captain. I hope you're enjoying your visit to Alderaan. But if you're here about Denry Ale, I must disappoint. I've been gathering information, yet I cannot locate him with any certainty.
An exchange, Baron. I'll share my information if you'll share yours.
I'm more than willing. May I? These records, they are the pieces of a puzzle my own sources left incomplete. It appears that some weeks ago, Master Ale arranged a secret meeting with House Rist. That meeting is doubtless occurring as we speak.
I'll have to crash their party.
I'd caution you to leave this matter alone. House Rist is a stain upon the nobility. A house of slayers and poisoners. I suggest you wait for Denry Ale's return. A month, perhaps two. Don't earn the Rist assassin's ire by interfering in their affairs.
Unfortunately, my mission is urgent.
I admire your energy, but these games should be played with caution. Confronting Rist will do no good. Now, I must cut this discussion short. I have other matters to attend to. See to our guest, my lady. Make certain Cortes hospitality remains second to none.
I'm sorry about my husband. He's a busy man, and a brave one. Just not brave enough to confront the House Rist.
A war against House Rist would get both of you killed.
He believes that. Maybe he's right. Maybe that's why I'm so frustrated. Everything the Baron said about Rist is true. They are a stain on society, and a foe of Cortes. When I was a child, Rist assassins poisoned my father and slit my brother's throat. Justice was never done.
If Rist is so abhorrent, why let them continue?
The Baron won't listen to my ideas. But you could show him the meaning of bravery. You could show all the houses that defying Rist isn't hopeless. Find Denry Ale, fight the assassins, and go with all our hopes.
I can't promise anything.
If that's how you feel, then I won't take any more of your time. Farewell. I'll make sure the Baron hears of your eloquence.
Ah! I was starting to wonder if we'd meet face to face. Welcome to House Rist. My name is Denry Ale, but of course you know that, and so much more, after stealing my records.
How do you know who I am?
I'm no fool. I hear you've been looking for me for some time. Did the Empire hire you, mercenary? Or is there a bounty on my head? Not that it matters. When we heard you were on your way, I arranged for my friends, at considerable expense, to prepare a traditional Rist welcome.
Why don't I show you a traditional Imperial welcome instead?
And I'll show you how to die!
You worthless filth! You may have killed me, but you can't take away what I've achieved. I worked for peace on Alderaan. I showed the houses how to settle their differences. What have you ever done for decent men?
I protect decent people from terrorists like you.
You blind fanatic. You never understand.
Master Aang, I'm sorry to disturb, but this message must reach you in time. The situation's grown worse. The thorn in my side knows you're visiting House Rist, and I believe she'll soon give chase. She's dangerous, Denry. She's in league with my husband, and somehow gained access to your personal journals. You're going to need protection. I know the Rists aren't committed to working for us yet, but I hope you can convince them to help you. I'm sure you can sway them somehow. You've a way with words.
Halt! Leave Cortes lands immediately, or be forcibly expelled.
Let me guess. Baroness Che doesn't like me anymore.
The Baroness has revoked your access to the estate. She's ordered all defenses raised. You may as well turn around. We've got blast doors, force fields. This estate is designed to repel an army.
The Baroness is funding terrorists, and I have proof.
I'm not interested in your proof. I'm interested in removing a threat to my house. All droids, attack now!
Fun. I don't think blasters are going to get us through here, Agent. Maybe we should talk to your bug boy.
Agent. Come inside. The nest is prepared to defend you.
Yeah, that's what you need these bugs for. Defending us.
Our observers saw what happened. Why did Cortes turn on you? How can we help?
Turns out the Baroness is working with the terrorists.
The Baroness? This is unexpected. The nest has studied the Cortes estate's defenses and deemed them formidable. The interior shields are designed for squads of human attackers. The perimeter security systems are meant to combat armies and Killik swarms.
Can we disable the shield somehow?
The power generators are behind the main estate. They're well guarded, but they might be sabotaged from the inside. If I could reach the generators, I could release a swarm of fingerling Killiks. Our smallest brethren can easily slip through the cracks and damage the machinery.
You've got miniature saboteur bugs.
Yes. There are times when smaller bodies prove useful.
If you two are taking out the shield generators, I'll keep the Cortes patrols busy. Maybe poach something nice.
We'll meet up after this is over.
You and Bug Boy have a good time.
Each of us can carry a handful of fingerling eggs. Once our young destroy the shield generator, we can proceed inside. Fingerlings have ruined the power generators. We should find Baroness Che.
What have you done?
Baron, I beg of you.
You have made an enemy of the Empire. You have brought vermin into my house.
I swear, I only wanted to protect us.
Silence! My honored guest, I bow my head in surrender, and I apologize for what's become of Cortez.
I'm here for your wife, Baron. She's committed terrorist offenses against the Empire.
I fought the only way I could. All I ever had was money.
Our reinforcements have arrived. We will attack on your signal.
I knew nothing of my wife's conspiracy. She only confessed once the house defenses were down. But I will make amends. Now, Captain.
You're an honorable man. I appreciate your sacrifice.
I had no other choice. Now, take your insects away from this place. We can discuss further recompense as civilized people.
We're afraid that's not your decision, Baron. Denry Ale and the Baroness are dead. With our assistance, the terrorist funding has been stopped. Now the Nest will claim its price.
What are you talking about, Vector?
House Cortez will make a perfect extension of the Hive. These rooms will become egg chambers and ambrosia pools. The family can become joiners.
What? You cannot do this! I gave you my wife!
House Cortez opposed the Empire and must be subdued. The Nest is growing and must expand its territory.
Do what you have to do. I'm finished here.
Excellent. We will secure the estate. The injured will be tended to and transformed. The dead will feed the larvae.
Damn you! Damn all of you! House Cortez will have revenge!
Protect the Baron and attack!
The Hive is secure. The injured will be tended to and transformed. The dead will feed the larvae.
It's all over then. The terrorists and Cortez gone.
They will become valued members of the Nest. Now, we'd like to bring this mission to a close. With your permission, we'll upload House Cortez's data to Imperial Intelligence.
This is Keeper to Cipher 9. I'm receiving your transmission. Watchers are reviewing the Cortez logs now. It looks like you've wrapped up the terrorist financing situation. Congratulations.
I'm proud to be of service, sir.
Preliminary analysis suggests the Eagle's terror network will run low on funds within weeks. The cells will look for alternative credit sources, of course. Let's not give them the chance to find any.
We'll keep them on the run. Anything else?
One other thing. I contacted Vector's superiors in the diplomatic service, and we've reached an agreement.
Sir?
Your requisition has been made permanent. You've been officially transferred to Imperial Intelligence. Cipher 9, from now on, Vector Hellas will act as a covert assault agent under your command. Understood?
Understood. Welcome aboard, Vector.
We'll do our best to live up to expectations.
Once you're through on Alderaan, return to your ship for debriefing. Watcher 2 should have updates ready for you. In the meantime, instruct Vector as you see fit. I expect he'll require additional training.
I'm sure Vector and I will make a good team.
Good. Stay alert, Cipher. Keep her out.
The Nest is pleased with the Empire and encourages this opportunity. We remain Dawn Herald, but we will travel at your side.
You've been with the Kilix a long time. Any anxiety about leaving the Hive?
Perhaps. It has been our home since transformation. But we've always been an emissary. First from the Empire to the Kilix, and now from the Kilix to the galaxy. It should be a fascinating experience.
Thank you.
This is Watcher 2 to Cipher 9. Verify that you're receiving and prepare for takeoff. We've located the Eagle.
Tell me where.
We knew the Eagle had abandoned his old base, but until you neutralized that last cell, we didn't know the details. Now we do. The Eagle is on Hutter. Get there as soon as you can.
It all comes back to the beginning.
For you, at least. I have to go now, Cipher, but I'll brief you on site. Watcher 2 out. Signal received. Transmission secure. All right, Cipher. Looks like this is the real thing. Ready to invade the Eagle's nest?
You'd better believe it.
The Eagle and his men are holed up in an old refinery beneath the river. Sending coordinates now. You'll lead the forward assault, but military reinforcements will surround the base and follow you in. Primary objective is to capture or eliminate the Eagle himself.
Acknowledged and understood.
Your secondary objective is the Eradicators. The terrorists have begun launching their biomechanical weapons over Imperial worlds. Once the devices are ready, the terrorists can fire on cities and military bases from orbit.
We'll find a way to stop them.
I hope so. After the Dominator, everyone who died along with Darth Jadis, I don't want to go through that again. When you're in that base, don't let anyone escape. Don't let the Eagle murder again. Watcher 2 out.
Sir, we're cut off. Thurston and Gerald tried to get out, but the Imperials are all over the swamps.
They would be. Damnation. I promised Gerald she'd die with the detonator in one hand and a glass of brandy in the other. Seems she's made a liar of me.
I'm sorry, sir.
Don't be. You were everything I could have hoped for. Now carve us a path out. I'll follow soon. All right, I see you. The least I could do was send the boy off with hope. But have you seen the strength of the revolution? Cells on Nar Shaddaa, Tholot and Molovar, Alderaan, Balmora. It's an inspiration, no matter how it ends.
When it ends with your death, you won't be so inspired.
It won't end with my death, though. It won't even end on Eradication Day.
Star
sign, please. Oh, damnation. Even surrounded, even seeing you, I didn't think it would happen like this. But you haven't won. The Eradicators will still activate. Even without orders, without targets, they'll shoot blind. Random. Fire will rain upon the Empire.
How do I stop them, Eagle? Talk.
You don't. Not without the codes. And even I only have half. The Eradicators won't hit my targets, but rampant, they'll cause chaos and death. You should be proud. One of your own people proposed the devices. My patron, a servant of the Empire behind it all.
Give me a name.
If I had one, I might. But I never learned the truth. Goodbye now. Watch me burn.
He has a detonator. Get back.
Area is clear. Sir, are you all right?
Cipher 9, it's Watcher 3. Are you hurt? That was a nasty explosion.
A little singed, but better than the Eagle.
That really was him? Fantastic. Keeper sent me to assist with information retrieval, slicing the Eagle's computers. I'll also check out that device there. I think it's an Eradicator.
Move fast. The Eradicators may still be a threat.
Yes, sir. Cipher, I've got some preliminary findings. It's not good news. I overheard what the Eagle said. Looks like he was telling the truth. If no one gives the Eradicators new orders, they'll go mad. Fire randomly.
Any idea how to disable them?
Here's the good part. I figured out their control mechanism. transmit the proper codes, and you can set the device's targets, disable them, anything. The Eagle stored half the control codes on his computers. Someone else must have the second half.
The Eagle mentioned a patron.
Yes, sir. The one inside the Empire. I'm not sure what that means. You should head to Drummond Cass. I don't think there's anything more you can do here, and Keeper wants you back at headquarters.
Cipher 9, come inside. This should be a triumphant moment. It's a tremendous achievement bringing down the Eagle. The crisis has only escalated. The Eradicators could begin firing at any moment.
I understand, sir.
Watcher 2, your report.
The Moths have placed local forces on alert, and a search for the Eradicators is underway. Unfortunately, trends suggest we can only find one device every 5 hours. It'll be weeks before we destroy them all.
Disappointing, but not a surprise. Damage projections?
Estimates are 10 to 50 million deaths on each planet targeted. 40% military, 60% civilian.
Even at the low end, that's unacceptable.
Agreed. It sends the message that the Empire is vulnerable.
In order to deactivate the Eradicators en masse, we need the control codes. Half the codes were on the Eagle's computers. We can only surmise that the other half are with the Eagle's patron.
Yes, the patron. A man whom the Eagle claims is inside the Empire.
You sound skeptical.
I have my doubt that this patron is really a highly placed Imperial. It seems unlikely such a person could escape our scrutiny. Nonetheless, we can't ignore the possibility of a traitor. That's why we're meeting privately. Only the people in this room know the full situation.
Caution would seem prudent.
Indeed. Watcher 2?
The Eagle had been sending periodic transmissions to someone in the Artis system. Artis is uninhabited, devoid of resources, and off the major hyperlanes. Our patron could certainly hide there.
I want you to lead a mission to Artis. You're to find the Eagle's patron and obtain his half of the control codes. Watcher 2 will rendezvous with you there. She knows more about the Eradicators than anyone.
I'll be glad to have her around. We'll get the job done.
Your ships will be outfitted with cloaking devices. They'll only last one jump, but they'll get you into Artis unnoticed. After that, infiltrate whatever base the patron is using. Recover the Eradicator control codes and stop the threat. Watcher 2, you're dismissed.
If you want to talk before the mission, I'll be at my station.
There is one more thing. Darth Sorid heard you were returning to Drummond Cass. She wants to speak to you.
She's insane. You know that, right?
Yes, I know. I've done my best to shield intelligence from our new lord. You've been the unfortunate exception. Do what it takes to survive Zorid's attentions a little longer. Beyond that, the Dark Council won't let this continue forever.
I believe I understand.
When you're through, head to the Artis system. This is our only chance, Cipher. Fail, and we all pay a grievous cost.
Cipher. I'm glad you stopped by. I've been going over the mission parameters, studying the Eradicator control code, scans of the Artis system. We're facing a mystery, and I hate mysteries.
You may hate mysteries, but you're pretty good at solving them.
I am. I don't mind having that recognized, call it vanity, but I like knowing my creation served a purpose. What about you? What's been going through your head since this countdown to Eradication Day started?
All I can think is that someone's betraying us.
Don't. Keeper knows the players involved, and Lodenth and I can run the psychological profiles. If someone's disloyal, we'll find out.
At least there are some people we can trust.
It's worth remembering. You've been a good partner, you know. A struggle, sometimes. But you know what you're doing. I admire that.
That's nice to hear you say.
In any case, you should get ready. The Eradicators won't wait for either of us.
No time for chat, then.
Even less than usual. Once you take off for the Artis system, I'll be on your tail. We'll meet out there.
physical trauma includes electrical burns, lacerations, and retinal damage. Transfer to a Colto tank for long-term recovery is strongly recommended.
You suggest a Dark Council member hide in a vat? For healing?
I am programmed to dispense medical advice based on all relevant factors.
Get out! Have yourself disassembled, made into a probe, and sent to the most desolate place in the Empire! Look, Agent, they hurt me, and then they laughed. How could they?
Who did, my lord?
After Vioriannal broke, I called the Council to assembly. I demanded the Lords give me the respect I was due. Some were angry, mocked me. They tormented me and warned me not to overstep my bounds again.
The Dark Council did this.
They called me an arrogant child, unworthy of my position. It's all Jadis' fault. He was my master, but he never taught me what I needed to know. Now he's dead, and I'm not ready for his council seat.
I don't know what to tell you. I'm so sorry.
For letting my father get assassinated, or for failing me. I know what's happening in Imperial Intelligence. I know you're going on a mission, and that the Eagle wasn't the man you thought. Swear that you'll find whoever really killed my father. Swear that the man responsible will pay for forcing me into this wretched life.
I swear I will make him pay.
Yes. You will exact my revenge. And the world will be made right. I have gifts for you, Agent. Take them with my blessing and leave me to salt my wounds. And to gain strength from my hatred.
This place is stark. We smell no pheromones, feel no auras. We should be cautious.
Cypher, there's no one to welcome us. Seems our cloaking devices worked.
Good to see you too. How was the flight?
Uneventful, fortunately. I stayed in your wake. This starship is a modified Imperial Dreadnought, maximum crew complement of 5,000. It's also jamming long-range communications, so I can't check its registration or call for reinforcements.
Our traitor is hiding his tracks.
Nonetheless, top priority is finding the eradicated command codes before the weapons initiate a random firing pattern. This data spike contains our half of the codes. Once you obtain the other half, you should be able to control the eradicators from any computer.
Any idea where the codes might be stored?
If we're lucky, they'll be on the bridge computers, and you can deactivate the eradicators from there. If they're not, I don't know. I do have one other thing for you. A comlink implant. So long as you're wearing it, I can monitor your situation and speak to you privately.
Is this one-way communication, or can I reply?
Subvocally. Whisper to me, and no one else will hear. While you search the interior, I'll try to slice the security systems. We're counting on you. Put an end to this.
It's a grand social experiment. There's probably 100 of us from across the Empire. All saved from the fire. Who knows how or why. For the most part, we're left to ourselves. Squabbling and fighting. Left to fear our own shadows. But we know the Master's out there. And I'm convinced there's a plan at work. Somebody wants to change us. Someone wants to control us. It's been... I don't know how long it's been. I lose count of the days during the blackouts. The ones furthest along. They say our terror transforms us into the Master's image. Well, I'll tell the Master what's really happening. We're learning to fight back. Do you hear me, Master? We'll kill you for this. We'll kill you!
I was so happy when I got the invitation. Everything was going to change for me. Leave home for a year. Why has the Master picked me to survive when hundreds died? And now the rest of us, one by one. My mother was a slave, but I wasn't, because my father was an officer. I don't want to end up like her. Oh, please. Please, someone rescue us.
Something's wrong. Like, rot within the hive. There is taint spreading through the Unity.
So, you've arrived at last.
Cypher, I know that voice.
I expected too little of you. You served me well on Hutter and on Dromund Kaas. I should have known you would serve me again.
Are you responsible for this?
Everything that has transpired has been at my command. My will is the destiny of lesser men. Once before, you were inoculated by the dark side. I will speak now as I spoke then. Accept the gift of your life, Agent, and we will discuss Terror, the Empire, and the Sith.
As you wish.
Be careful, Cypher. Please be careful.
I'm trying to analyze the situation, but it'll take time, and if he has the command codes...
It was my desire that the Eagle unite the Terror cells. It was my desire that my flagship be destroyed. I required a weapon that the Dark Council would overlook. The terrorists became my unknowing servants and carried out my plan.
What does the Dark Council have to do with this?
Everything. A member of the Council is forced to politic, to struggle against his rivals. The waste is unimaginable. With my false death, I escaped the eyes of the Dark Council and of Imperial Intelligence. After the Dominator, I came here, bringing with me those passengers worthy of elevation. I maneuvered my pieces into place.
What's the point of it all?
Keep him talking. Damn it. We can't fight him on our own. His power is second to the Emperor's.
I accomplished two things during my absence. First was the diminution of the Dark Council. Upon my death, my former enemies began warring amongst themselves, vying to claim my resources. Darth Jorid's arrival escalated the chaos. My daughter is doomed, but she is an adequate distraction.
I can't call for reinforcements so long as that jamming field is active. But he'll annihilate anything less than an army.
You said your death accomplished two things. One was weakening the Council. What was the other?
Throwing the Sith into disorder was only the start. The rest of the Empire had to be prepared as well. That was the Eagle's purpose, to sow fright and hatred. All this while, my Eradicators were growing. Now they are ready, and my victory is close at hand.
What victory? What are you talking about?
The Eradicators will destroy the strongholds and apprentices of my enemies on the Council. So too will the Eradicators terrorize the Empire. Then I will return to the Council and lead the Empire into a new age, an epoch of terror.
The Emperor won't let you get that far.
The Emperor is distracted. I could re-sculpt the Dark Temple into a monument to my glory, and he would fail to object. Perhaps I shall do exactly that.
I see where this is going. He needs the Eradicators to make this work, but you have half the command codes.
Under my rule, all people will revel in fear and degradation. These prizes will no longer be hoarded by Sith. But without both halves of the Eradicator codes, my weapons cannot be targeted. They will merely cause chaos.
Mere chaos isn't enough for you, is it?
No. The Eagle's death, your acquisition of his codes, has forced me to adapt. Without orders, the Eradicators will fire blindly. This serves neither of us. Enter your codes into the ship so the Eradicators can target my enemies. You will be rewarded. You will be my herald.
Last time you promised me something, you faked your own death.
I misunderstood your role. Consider what I can offer now. Authority, wealth, a place in my vision. The respect intelligence has denied you.
What does that mean?
Blood purity is a notion whose time has passed. Consider an empire where there is no limit to what an alien might become.
I need some time. It's a lot to take in.
Very well. But understand this. If you refuse, you will die at my hand. The Eradicators will still reap untold destruction. Your sacrifice would mean nothing. I can be merciful. Take the time to consider your choice. Then we can begin the true work.
Yes, my lord.
Think on my words, Agent, and embrace my will.
All right, stay focused and don't look at Jadis. How are you holding up? Can we put together a plan?
I'm all right, but I don't think we have much time.
We need to re-examine our priorities. We came here to stop the Eradicators, but we weren't prepared for reality. Our plan now has to focus on neutralizing Darth Jadis. Everything else is peripheral.
There's still an imminent attack to worry about.
I'm sorry, Cypher. The numbers aren't in our favor. You can deactivate the Eradicators right now. Just combine the codes in the bridge computers. But to keep Jadis from reactivating them, you'd have to blow up the ship's reactor. It's a suicide run, and chances are, Jadis would escape.
The Eradicators would be disabled. That was our mission.
It's not that simple. If Darth Jadis escapes, he'll come back. Not next year, maybe, but eventually. There's another way. A way to stop him from hurting anyone again. We can lure him into a trap by earning his confidence. Give him the codes to the Eradicators, and let him launch his attack.
Say what you have to say.
Prove your loyalty, and he'll turn his back on you. He's too arrogant to do otherwise. Once the Eradicators start their bombardment, you slip off the bridge and take the ship apart. You sabotage the jamming field, hyperdrive, and shields. Then I can call in reinforcements. The military, the Dark Council, forcing Jadis to surrender. The Eradicators are deactivated as soon as feasible.
How many people, how many worlds are sacrificed?
Let's be clear. If we give Jadis the command codes, then yes, he'll murder thousands before we stop him. But the human cost is acceptable. The only alternative is to let Jadis escape and do worse down the line.
The human cost isn't acceptable to me.
I can't tell you what to do, Cypher. If you disable the Eradicators here and now, I'll help you. We'll destroy this ship, save a lot of people, in the short term. But my advice is this. Use the codes to let Jadis launch his attack. Sacrifice lives and seize this chance. We can end his threat forever. Eradicators are offline. Repeat, the Eradicators are offline. Let's hope this works.
I expected more of you. Disabling the Eradicators will not stop me. You will die unmourned, and I will reactivate the devices and begin my assault.
You won't do anything if this place is dust.
He'll kill you, Cypher.
You can't fight Jadis, but you might slow him down. This ship can generate internal ray shielding.
Now, kneel before your doom.
If you can reroute the power, we can trap him in a force field, then get to the reactor core and destroy this ship. Uploading bridge schematics. You'll need to take out these components to reroute power to the force fields. Hit him now! I still need more power to get that force field up. Keep him distracted, and I can raise the force field. Almost there, Cypher. Just a little more. Slicing into the ratio controls now.
Not escape me. Your cage cannot hold me.
Ship's power level's becoming unstable. You did it, Cypher. This whole place is about to explode.
Give me a status update. The Sith?
Out of the force field and on his way to a shuttle. I can't abort the launch. He's got a clean escape.
If there's more... Now's the time to tell me.
I'm taking off, but I'll wait in system as long as I can. You need to get out before the reactor detonates. Good luck.
I'm on the assist.
I was afraid you wouldn't make it, Cypher. Good to see you alive. The self-destruct sequence is complete.
Jadis' ship has been reduced to cinders in Artis V's gravity well, and the Eradicator command codes went with it.
Any way to know what he'll do next?
No. I didn't even get a course projection when his shuttle jumped to hyperspace. I'm sending a message to Keeper. These events will cause complications among the Sith, but I expect the Dark Council will sort matters quietly. They'll keep Jadis on the run, and we stopped a massacre.
I know you had doubts about the plan.
I ran the numbers. I dread the day Jadis returns and what he'll do. But the call was yours, and I'm glad no one had to die.
The Song of the Universe favors our actions. The Nest, our empire, is stronger for it.
I'm glad you were here to help.
So are we. We've often been uncertain about our place in intelligence, but not right now.
The Bug Boy has a point. He didn't do bad. I'd have gutted the Sith, though.
If we run into Jadis again, I'll see what I can do.
I'll hold you to it.
I'll see you at headquarters, Cypher. Enjoy the downtime while it lasts. There'll be debriefings, cleanup, and sooner than you think, Keeper will have your next assignment.
See you back at home, Watcher 2.
Mission accomplished. Watcher 2 out.
Agent, we're finalizing our exit report for the diplomatic service. 34 pages of seating charts, ambassador profiles, and appendices. We'll transmit it to our superiors, and then we're yours full time.
Any second thoughts about leaving diplomacy for intelligence?
We'll miss it, and we're sorry to hand over the unfinished work, but they'll do fine without me. You know, we used to advise first contact missions to new star systems. We met some unusual people, but we haven't had many new experiences since joining the Kilix. Time to broaden our horizons.
To see everything fresh from a Kilix perspective?
Something of the sort. Tastes, sounds, smells. They're all a bit different. But we won't bore you. Lead the way.